to spend my time with you. I said, oh, oh, you know I'd like to spend my life with you. I said, oh, oh, you know I'd love to spend my life.
What up, what up? It is Friday. That means it's Unfiltered and Unaffected right here on worldviral.tv.
That's Spice One's Roach.
Yeah.
Spice One's Roach.
That's Spice One's Roach. You found it.
Any roach that's in there is forever and it's always gonna be will Spice be Spice One. Ones. Yeah. Yeah.
Spice One was here and left a roach.
I love Spice so, One. Why was he not here when I was here?
Oh, he can be.
Maybe he was. He was watching you.
Welcome to the program. The intro was fucking superb again.
Yeah, as always.
We've gone zero shows in a row with a good open.
What? That was the best. That was the one you wanted, dude. That was like the touchdown.
It was?
Like, oh yeah, I was like three.
Oh
two,
no, you cued me to the mic.
What?
But you had this whole production ready, and no.
Oh yeah, it yeah.
That was a shit show.
It's still playing.
Bad. Welcome to the shit show.
It was bad. Sitting next to me.
Who's this hot broad?
Is not a dude.
I said
totally
broad.
Not a dude, but I'm wearing a dude jersey,
yeah.
And a shirt.
Many of you may or should. If you don't, pull your head out from under the rock and start doing some Google.
No, Frank knows me. He's on my MySpace. See,
Frank, oh.
I know, still.
Frank, really?
Fucking my? Frank and Tom.
Frank and the MySpace. Miss Tracy Taylor, you will know her from Fuck Alice, KYGO.
Fuck Alice.
You brought her.
Fuck Alice. Cool 105?
Cool 105, The Wolf.
Yeah, and then Vegas for a couple years.
Yeah.
She left most of it in Vegas.
Yeah.
The doctor said she's no longer susceptible.
Yeah, no, I didn't slip and fall in Vegas.
Yeah, so we're good.
I was good.
There.
Yeah.
Man, from all over the place. She's done everything. She's been everywhere. She's way more qualified to sit behind a mic than me.
Oh, that's
so
fine.
I just feel... I feel very proud to have you here.
Well, I'm very happy to be here. I know that we're going to talk about football. You said we're talking about football today.
Football.
So Peyton Manning's coming in, you said?
Not Peyton Manning.
But why did I wear my Peyton Manning jersey?
I may have told you Peyton Manning.
You said to make sure you, that said, you showed up. Wait, you said that we were talking about the Broncos and football and stuff.
Yes.
So Peyton Manning's going to come on.
Right.
Is he or is he not? Are we having a Bronco here or not?
There's a Bronco scheduled to be on the show.
Well, then I'm going to change it to my Ray Rice jersey.
Yes.
Okay.
Ray Rice. Oh, no.
Oh, wait. Oh, no. I don't have the other camera hooked up.
Are we good?
Oh, we're good.
This is my new Ray Rice jersey.
Oh. Ouch.
You like that?
Yeah.
Mm.
All right.
Is it official?
It's more comfortable.
Tracy, I'm not going to... I'm usually one that steps on the line. That might be a little too soon.
Too soon? Just too soon is making that motherfucker a sushi roll.
There you go.
Called Ray.
Ray. Give Rice. Me the Ray roll.
Yeah, I'll take one. I'll take two Rays and have the sushi master beat it down and then just give it to me like deconstructed on the plate.
Hey, right? I think we have Matt McChesney too, right?
We can build her back.
Oh, is that... Oh, yeah.
Do we have a
Who's that?
That's the cricket soundtrack.
Oh, oh hey! Hey, Matt, girl, hey!
Matt's here.
That's really nice.
Former Denver Bronco, number 60, Matt McChesney on the show.
Right here.
Hi, Matt.
Maybe next week.
Looking good.
Maybe next week.
Maybe he'll wear his Ray Rice jersey.
Hey, we have a Jessica Taylor over here. Wave, Jessica.
Hi,
that's our
Jessica.
Intern, Jessica. Jessica's the shit. She got Tracy a drink.
She knows how to use the soda machine.
She's way smarter than me.
We actually do have a kick-ass show.
Yeah, we have a great show online today. Monika Leigh, former contestant on The Voice.
Former or up-and-comer?
No, I think it's from last season.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay.
Last season.
I'm a big fan, and it debuts on my birthday Monday. So this is kind of like my birthday show. Can I have a party hat, Jess, or something?
Yeah, you can have...
Can I get balloons and
you can have the Ray Rice wolf mask.
Okay. All right. Like my birthday show. So the voice on my birthday.
You have to wear your birthday suit.
I can't wait to hear her.
She is a Colorado gal, which is cool.
Her backstory.
We always want to know. They're overnight sensations.
I love it.
We've never done anything except for one tryout with The Voice.
Right, and then just, boom, seriously, yeah, here's your record deal.
That's probably him. Also on the show today is Chris Miller from Chris Miller TV. Mm-hmm. Also the innovator of Koios, the smart supplement that I take. It's brain food.
This is how he focuses.
Right, this is how I stay.
Show.
Did you hear my shit going crazy?
I know, what's going on, Facebook? Have you ever been with someone and they answer their Twitter while you're...
Really?
No.
No,
Joe.
No.
Yeah. Rude.
Has that happened to you?
Well, maybe at one point.
That was just...
I mean, asking for a friend. I was asking for a friend.
Okay.
Yeah. It never happened to me.
Never?
Never Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. Why was I on Instagram?
How were you on Instagram?
Why do you post pictures while we're doing it?
Somebody wasn't doing their job.
I'm just kidding.
If you're doing the work correctly, it's almost physically impossible to be on Instagram.
It's not.
No?
No.
You're trying to get third party, you know?
No, no third party needed. Just think about your webcam.
Oh,
okay.
But you can't Instagram.
She's a step ahead of us, dude.
You just go click Instagram, upload, and all of a sudden my... Something. No, I don't need this.
Tracy Taylor is highly...
I have to be out of the room.
She's
and
highly
I don't
evolved.
Want to see the dimming lights.
Now, listen.
You don't have your tricks.
I just found this app not long ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's called At Home Camera. You don't even want to fuck around now. Seriously, you do not want to fuck around.
Okay, tell me what more can fuck my life up besides the iCloud, which is going to cause me an iDivorce.
No. Wait. This is going to fuck you up even more.
No.
There's an app out. It's called At Home Camera. You can take a cell phone that's not even hooked up. Like the one that you have in your drawer that was 2 years ago that you're not using. As long as it can connect to the Wi-Fi, you download this app and you click go and you set the fucking phone anywhere. I can now leave the house. And as long as I have the QR code that goes to that phone.
So fucking screwed.
I can now watch that camera off the cell phone from anywhere with sound.
At Home app?
Yeah, At Home.
Because the new app I was going to introduce on the show today is this one that you can hide dirty pictures behind a calculator. And it's a calculator, and it works as an actual calculator, but if you press in your code 7844, not my code, that's somebody else's code, then all of your pics pop up.
All right.
Yeah.
I think they already have that app. But it's
no, I know. It's a calculator and it hides So if you, it's a real calculator.
So you see the ApiPresit.
You see the ApiPresit calculator, 2 + 2 = 4. Oh, innocent calculator, dumb calculator. Right. This ain't porn. Uh-uh. You press in your birthday or whatever your 4-digit code is. It's always the same for me.
7448.
Whatever. And boom, porn.
So like 7448 pound opens it.
Right,
pound.
That'll open it, and then it's all those pictures that you don't want on your camera.
You should
camera.
Always have to press pound when you're going to the dirty pictures.
Yeah.
I think so too.
Yeah. I mean,
it's a hashtag
just
for, too.
Just pound.
Pound.
Did he really just do?
We should just change. Yeah, I just did that. Pound. We should change it from hashtag to pound.
Pound.
Yeah,
pound.
Just pound.
That's what
pound.
It used to be, the pound symbol.
Yeah.
Right.
What's up with that?
Before it had any use whatsoever. Just because I read stupid shit all the time, I was reading something a couple weeks ago that the at symbol was going to be eliminated from keyboards like 20 years ago.
Oh.
Except for the guy that was writing the code to create email used that symbol as...
So it got stuck.
So then it came back into use because it was used for nothing and it was so rarely used on the keyboard, they were going to eliminate it. Then when they wrote the code for email, they wrote in the at symbol.
Are you an emoji guy? I can speak with some friends strictly emoji, and then it has to be a full conversation with punctuation with other people. So,
I'm about 30% emoji literate.
Okay, well, there's a whole new bank of emojis coming out, like 200 that are coming out this week.
That I need, I'm sure.
Oh, I'm sure, but there's a couple of things that could be suggested that aren't on there, and they're not on the new up and comer list, and you know. The eggplant can only be used so many times.
What is the eggplant?
Yeah, for? What's the eggplant?
You don't know what the eggplant's no. used for? You haven't no. seen the eggplant?
Yeah, I know what it is. I just...
The emoji of the eggplant?
Oh, it's...
Yeah.
Just,
it's
just the, like
bend
a,
to the left.
Right. Right.
Slide bend to the
Slide
left.
Slide bend to the left. It's only so many times I can get my point across with an eggplant before people start
boy.
Asking questions.
Yeah.
Right.
See,
I'm not fucking vegetables, okay?
This is why I told you I'm 30% emoji literate. Now I know the eggplant.
Yeah, so I definitely
think a lot of text messages now have a completely different meaning.
Right. Now I think they need like a straight up dildo. So you just know what you're
they
getting
should get,
into
right
off the
it
bat.
It should be way easier.
Right. And like why not like a pickle? There's no pickle emoji.
Cucumber?
Nope.
Cucumber or pickle? Cuz both of those we understand.
Either or not there. Doesn't exist. And then there's this thing that looks like a shish kebab, but it looks like it has ice cream on it. I don't even know what the
you
fuck
can't
it
have
is.
An ice cream
I don't want
kebab.
That.
This shit is not going to last.
It's going to melt, and that's county fair food. I don't eat fair food.
Oh, I do.
You do?
Oh, fuck. You have no idea.
Shit on a stick?
Here's the deal. There's two me's. There's me that's in fight camp.
Because I was going to say, you're all like fit and trim and all.
There's me that's in fight camp who eats paleo, completely paleo.
And what is that? Nothing?
Caveman shit. It's like I eat meat and green vegetables. Like chicken, fish, and green vegetables, and maybe some brown rice if I'm splurging. That's fight camp food. That's all I eat.
Is pot a vegetable?
Pot is green. Okay. It's like a superfood.
Okay.
And then there's other life me when I'm not in fight camp. You can't fucking deep fry enough shit for me to eat in one day.
Have you had the Oreos, the deep fried Oreos?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Offensive.
Are you kidding me?
He's like, I invented the deep fried Twinkie.
You don't understand. I would eat deep fried fucking cow turd.
Wow.
If you put the right sauce with it.
Well, I've got a fair for you going to go to down at Colorado
How you spell Kios or Koios?
K-O-I-O-S, Koios. I would deep fry my fucking Koios pills. Seriously, if I'm not in fight camp, here's how it fluctuates. I can be 185 pounds.
Right.
Or I can be 155 pounds.
See, I can be about my regular weight, and then I can eat, and you can, like, see the cheeseburger in my stomach.
Right.
And then I'm like, that's gross.
Yeah.
So then...
You gotta walk at, like... What
so
do you,
I'll
like
just
102?
Happy meal that shit.
103? What do you walk at?
Oh, no, about... No, way more than that.
No, bullshit.
Oh, no.
Well, I mean, you gotta factor in...
Well, yeah, that's 10 pounds.
Yeah,
so 120.
We'll give you 112, 115.
We'll give you 120. yeah, but no, I'm fine for my height and weight or whatever, but
I'm you're
just
proportionately
one of those,
thin.
I'm just thank you for
you're
that.
You're proportionately thin, I would say, yeah.
Say thank
well,
you.
Well, my wife is built very similar, and I mean, you guys have like same legs, same.
Yeah.
And she's 5'5", weighs like 98, 99.
So little.
Like if she puts on a coat and gets to 100, she does a happy dance.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you guys are very similar in size.
Yeah, I would like to do a happy dance when it goes scale goes down, not so much up. But yeah.
She actually,
So my fighting weight. I'm at fighting weight right now.
You're at your fighting. No, your fighting weight's lower than.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Oh.
I walk around at 170 pounds and fight at like 155.
Okay. So you're in a. Are you in the band? Wait, welterweight, bantamweight. What? Where am I? I know UFC shit. I watched some of those things up until, I don't know, Anderson Silva got his ass kicked and then I stopped watching.
He broke his leg.
I don't know what happened. I was bored. I got bored. It's like UFC 299 right now. And I remember watching it like UFC 56.
179.
Oh, 179. Yeah. Okay, well, I was back
we're
in the...
We're about to have 178.
I was back in the Couture days, in the Shamrock days.
Okay, perfect. You just named two names.
Yeah.
That landed... if do you watch... Like the bar rescue, the this rescue, the restaurant makeover. Randy Couture and Ken Shamrock are now doing a show called Gym Rescue.
Gym Rescue.
That was filmed here. The first episode was filmed here in Denver in Lakewood at Women's Gym.
Oh.
In which it was a female-only gym. Everything was fucking pink. Everything. The whole gym pink.
Which they I love Mason Pink, but...
Which they were converting to a male-female gym. And you know how they always bring in the grand opening crowd? That was all people from my gym.
Oh,
all invited to come and be the excited crowd.
Yay.
Yeah, so like three of the fighters from my gym, local comedian Heather Snow, who's a good friend of the show. She's there. They give her lines. She had to walk in and say, so I really need to join a gym and I'm uncomfortable with my body, so I thought a women's gym would be good because my boyfriend told me I need to lose 10 or 15 pounds.
Oh my God. Whoops.
Yeah, totally. Like the entire show, like we were talking about it the next day at the gym after it aired, and they're like, wow, we filmed that like 2 years ago, and I didn't remember how much stuff they told us that we had to say.
Right.
Yeah, the whole thing.
Total scripted.
The whole
I love gym scripted rescue. Reality is amazing.
Yeah.
Scripted reality.
Scripted
TV's
reality.
And then it's Ken Shamrock and Randy Couture.
Well, Randy's got a gym in Vegas. I've been there a number of times, and there's no, they don't fuck around there.
No.
And UFC being based in Vegas has been fun because it was actually directly across the street from our radio station, and nobody knew it. But I happen to
it's secret. Sniff out yeah, their headquarters
shit.
Is like that, no signage whatsoever.
Oh bullshit! Nothing secret in Vegas. But I'll find it. I'll
it's
find
secret
it.
To the like the normal.
Yeah, no, you can't. There's no addresses.
There's no signage out front.
There's no signage. There's nothing. But when you see Dana White walking into somewhere, you're like,
often he's walking in there.
Pretty much know that that's and it was right across from our radio station, which was kind of cool. So got to know a couple of the fighters and you know their parents and stuff. And one guy that worked with us is. The guy who checks the fighter right before he goes into the ring to make sure he doesn't have any razor blades.
Sure. The referee, the check-in referee outside.
Okay, that guy. Yeah. So I know that guy. His name's Chris. And hi, Chris. Hi, Chris. Mm-hmm. He's probably watching. Oh, hi, Chris. we would get to go to the UFC fights in Vegas, which were crazy to go to. I've never... To see it live is a whole nother deal. So,
it's
pretty
awesome,
impressed.
Huh? It's so fun.
How would somebody get a razor blade in? That's
well, just
saying,
that's what
just
I heard.
Saying, like possibly, they used to put razor blades in apples when I was growing up. I don't know what the fuck I was saying.
They check to make sure that your hand, your glove tape is still labeled as it was from the locker room. There's a judge or a commission officer in the back room. After your hands get taped, they check them and make sure that they fit the qualifications, which is acceptable by the fight commission. And then they put your gloves on. They tape around the glove on the wrist, and then they sign it in some way. So that
it's legit.
When you walk out to get checked in, they see that the same signature is there and it hasn't been tampered with so that there's no fist pack in your gloves or anything that'll do that. You know, they check
I meant
sure
fist packing.
Fist packing.
Fist
I meant
packing.
Fist packing.
Fist packing.
I would never say that.
They then
live
check
anything.
That your fingernails are trimmed. You don't have any.
I need a manicure terribly.
Anyway, that's what that guy does. He makes sure that everything is still within the spec that was.
And then he gets to sit there ringside and watch the fight and get blood splattered on him, and it's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean. I don't know. I like hockey blood because it bounces on ice. But I'll take some UFC blood too.
Any blood, yeah. Don't be afraid of the blood.
I'm not afraid.
Yeah.
I hate vampires, but
like
that's just dumb.
Well, sparkly vampires.
I can't even go where I want to go.
Anything sparkly is great.
No. Sparkly vampires
are terrible.
Did
you not see
my cup? Sparkly vampires are terrible.
Hey, hold up your cup so we can get a...
Oh. Yeah, what you bring in a different cup all the time. That's not a cup. That's like a fucking...
It's a rocket
like a
ship.
Bottle.
44 ouncer.
She's going deep.
that's what
I
he
mean,
said.
The straw into the cup. So other things going on in the let's break down. We have Monika Leigh from The Voice. We have Chris Miller from from Koyos coming in and Chris Miller TV. He also has the greatest music video ever that Chris, I'm sure, wants to show and you have to see.
Okay. Oh,
it's awesome. It's called
Sex with Single Moms.
Oh.
It's fucking great.
It's genius.
Sounds fantastic.
It's some good work.
Some topics that have been going through my mind recently. The iPhone 6 launches today.
Yes, it does.
There was a line at the Apple Store in New York City 12 blocks long.
When you can order it online a week early, why is there a fucking line?
What in the world would you stand in line for?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I stand in no lines.
Would you camp out?
I actually valet at concerts and pay $30 so I don't have to fucking walk across the street. Yeah. I stand in no lines. I am a crazy crowd person and I don't do it. I hate it. I would not stand in the line. And you know what? I don't need two new best friends on either side. It's like at Disneyland. That's what I have to fucking stand in line in because they make you. And I'm there with my parents and we have to go on every single ride.
You need a kid in the wheelchair.
My mom has a handicap placard. Don't think I wasn't about ready to throw that shit down.
There was a thing going on at Disneyland where people were hiring wheelchair kids.
Yeah.
To go with them to Disneyland.
Can't do anymore.
Oh, they don't do that anymore?
No. It has to be like legit. You got to like check the IDs and it's.
So it has to be your kid in a wheelchair.
It's got to be your kid. Yeah, you can't just be
carted. You can't hire a wheelchair kid anymore?
No.
Because that was fucking genius.
And hireawheelchairkid.com. I think I shut down last week. I don't know. But Disneyland is what I will stand in line for because I have to.
Right.
Because I have to. There is no want in any of that sentence. I have to. And so you end up in these 45-minute to an hour and a half lines, and you're making best friends with the person in front of you and the people in back of you because you're in line. So I've got fucking phone numbers from some dude in Britain. I've got a lady in San Diego, a guy in Chicago. I'm like, I've made friends from all over the land. Disneyland is the greatest place on earth.
Hey, can I just flash stuff like that on the screen?
What?
Dickhead.
Ah!
That's actually a dildicorn.
I love a dildicorn. That's fun. That would
sorry. Be,
I don't know where that came from. I don't think I would want but cool. to be on that, but thank
I think
you.
You and I are very similar in I actually have social anxiety disorder.
Yeah, I think I do too.
Crowds fuck me up.
Which they tell me, all my promotions people, I'm like, oh my gosh, I hate this. I don't want to go to these crowds and these concerts and I have to MC Red Rocks. It's like, ah. They're like, why the fuck did you pick this job? I'm like, because three quarters of the time I'm... Nobody can see me except
hey, Jess,
today.
Will you go let Chris Miller in the back door? I'm very much like you in the aspect I've become very spoiled in Denver as an R-list celebrity.
Oh, I know. I think I might be like a D.
You're definitely a D.
I'm definitely a D, although some guy...
Oh, you mean celebrity.
Some guy dicked me for concert tickets last night, which I thought was really cool.
When you say dicked...
John Morris, a.k.a. Arodi, a.k.a. your friend on Facebook, go ahead and unfriend now and then block his motherfucking ass, because nobody, for my birthday, gives me Jason Aldean tickets and then fucks me over on it when I make birthday plans.
He went super flake on you?
Super flake. And then sent
for
nasty.
Jason Aldean?
Sent nasty. Well, listen, I could give a rat. Listen, I've seen Jason Aldean 42 times at the very least. Hi, there's a big guy walking in here. Holy crap.
Hey.
So anyway, I just got fucked for tickets. Oh my God.
You didn't get fucked.
Fucked on the tickets.
Right. Fucked off four tickets.
This dude who blows up my Facebook with emojis and highs.
Don't sass me.
He's all up in my messenger and he's all this, that. That's how I was last week. That's nice.
Yeah.
He's all this, that, and the other. And then the day of the show that I need the tickets, nowhere to be found. I'm in a production meeting. I'm in a what? I'm like, shit.
Having been in this business for a long time,
I don't play. If I say I can deliver, those tickets are at will call. I never would do that.
You could wait for him to at least pass them out. It's very interesting when
you have drugs.
When you deal with people who have tickets or who are supposed to take care of something for you, the awesome ability for them to disappear when they can't deliver. Like they will respond to a text all week long within 5 seconds, 5 seconds, 5 seconds.
2 seconds.
Day of, all of a sudden.
Hours.
And you're like.
And I'm thinking, in a production meeting, can't talk. And I'm thinking, all you do all day and all weekend is I have just pages of this motherfucker blowing up my Facebook.
Yeah.
Just messages, winks. Hi, sweetie. So anyway, he's going to hook me up for Jason Aldean ticket. So I actually, for my birthday, make plans, which I never do because it never works out. I hate my birthday. So I make plans for my birthday to go to this stupid fucking concert. My birthday's Monday, which I've already mentioned, and I would accept presents at any time during the show.
PayPal?
PayPal's fine. And yeah, send her tits to McGee.com. I'm just joking. But yeah, don't you ever. Oh, you better don't. You might have could, but you better don't.
Yeah.
That's all I have. My mama said, you might have could, but you better don't.
That's the worst thing in the world is when people
I'm not going to show up at Red Rocks and go, hey, I'm Tracy Taylor, my ticket's at Will Call, and have some bitch tell me no and get into a fight with a gate agent at Red Rocks. Is this douche.
There's nothing worse than showing up to something that said they said it's already set up there, and then you show up and they're like, no, there's no tickets.
I've never had that happen.
I will fucking kill you.
I've never had that happen.
Watch your head. did you see that save?
Like, whoa. that could have been a really
I've become
feature.
Like I said, I've become very spoiled in Denver, just because I've been like,
we're networked way, in, dude. We right, can way, seriously, way I down. Can probably call the guy at Red Rocks and go, I want to come. Can I?
Yeah. I don't stand in line. I also normally don't stand in the crowd for a big show because people's energy fucks me up.
But I think I told you I took my daughter to One Direction and I was like, okay, this is how mommy gonna roll, okay? We valet park, I don't do opening bands, and I don't do encores. So that being said, get in the fucking car and we go to One Direction.
Yeah,
we're gonna I'm not gonna have parking right there at the door. I want my car there. It's the second that I'm leaving. I don't want to deal with the 17,000 little orgasms that are happening around me. I'm done. Over and out.
I was thinking orgasm. I'm sorry.
Sorry, Kyle.
What's this for? It's for you.
So you could pass it out directly on camera. There you go. So back to my, I think the original story from this was.
Am I allowed to talk yet?
Yeah, talk whatever you want. Ladies and gentlemen, a good friend of mine has been on the show several times. Not a good friend?
That's pushing it, Trev Bone. Is
this thing on? Fucking douchebag that I know.
Call it Trev Bone.
Yeah.
T-Bone.
Chris Miller.
I like the Trev Bone.
Chris Miller TV, Koyos, MentalTitan.com.
How do you define friends, I guess, is a better question.
How do I do?
If I was in a Turkish prison camp, would you come save me?
Yeah. No, but I would sneak in and let you blow me.
It's a fair deal.
It's a conjugal visit.
I'd rather suck your dick than some other stranger's dick.
Right, we know each other.
I know your dick.
We've done this.
It's like a protein shake.
Chris has the accolades of being the one show that I had in my old studio that got me in more trouble than any other fucking show I ever had. And we had, like, some rank shows.
I've only been on once.
Chris did not get me in trouble with my network. Chris got me in constant trouble with my building.
Oh.
I was telling Gina on the way down here that you told me once that, and Gina's an irrelevant character, if you're wondering.
Right, I'm like, Gina.
She's my driver.
Damn, Gina.
Fucking, don't worry about it, Gina. That Gina. You were like, your show's the only one that makes me uncomfortable, too. Like, there's moments.
I used to produce his show. I would produce his show, and I'm all about, let's push the fucking edge. Let's get all the way out to the edge, and then move the line a little bit further. There were times on his show where, and you can't make me uncomfortable, but his show would, I'd be like, ooh, I don't know if we can.
I think we'd probably do pretty let's well have together. Sex. I don't know what you're doing. I mean, that could happen.
Just kidding. I can you're slip married. And fall. I'm into it.
There was one time, Chris.
I swing. These have you been to Scarlet Ranch?
Right off. Humidity.
Chris was talking about wanting to have anal sex and was willing to allow, not only willing, allowed his partner at the time to put things in his ass so that he could then earn putting things in her ass.
No, hold on.
That's the trade. That's the trade.
The conversation was, can you hear me in this thing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ow, now, brown cow.
Yeah, that's really loud.
You're good.
We can hear you next time.
The intern can hear you, too.
I'm hyperactive.
her ears are scarred.
I have a
is
disorder.
That what you take to make you... Okay.
I'm naturally like this.
Oh, my God.
No, the conversation was, I was trying to be partisan about the whole anal sex thing because for whatever reason, I like it. I'm into it. I don't know. Maybe it's because it's the forbidden fruit. I just... whatever, I like to experiment. And so the conversation went down this line of like, if I'm going to put my penis in your butthole, then I think I should be pretty open about you putting stuff in my butthole. Hashtag no homo. It was just like, hey, like if you want to experiment on me,
that's the original
but I'm asking concept. You to experiment, no. Then I feel like...
Right, it's fair.
Yeah.
It's fair game.
But then we started talking about things I've actually had in my butt, and that's where it started to get a little uncomfortable.
Wow. And what all was
allowed in your ass? Let's go ahead and do this.
I had a few fingers in my butt.
Everybody's had at least a finger up to one.
She put a butt plug in there once. Which was better than the finger.
Ow.
Yeah, really? It's not that bad. No, it's because rubbery and slippery.
I'm like doing Kegels over here. I don't know.
Right now you're doing Kegels?
Right now.
I feel uncomfortable.
Now do you see where I ended up uncomfortable? Because at you can put a finger in. You know what?
I went to school to be a sex therapist. Go for it.
But if you want to slip a finger in,
get your fist in there. I don't know what to do.
That gets me anal. I'm good with a finger because there's not a woman alive who has really fingers that are bigger than a poop I've taken. So if it's smaller than a poop,
that'd be weird.
I'm kind of okay there.
You have poop sized fingers.
You took a butt plug.
Yeah, it's a small butt plug. It's not like it wasn't like a giant black dildo. It wasn't like.
What was the circumference?
I don't know, like less than a poop.
Koyos pill?
No. Bottle? Wow, that's a lot. I'm an entrepreneur now. I own a company.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
No, they're small. They're like that big.
Like hot dog.
But don't they get bigger as it goes?
Don't they have a taper?
No.
Oh.
The one we had.
Oh, it was just
I think that was just a dildo.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because a butt plug.
No, it had the stopper on the back. The backstop.
But a butt plug usually cones out and then cones back and then there's a stopper. Am I not true?
I've lived in Vegas long enough to know this, yes.
Don't they usually taper up and then down? And
yeah,
then
that's what I was asking. If it went like that, like if it got bigger.
I think it may have tapered just the gradient on it.
So we're saying gradient. You were like the virgin butt plug.
Yeah, it wasn't the advanced.
Like hot dog or smaller.
Yeah, it was hot dog or smaller. It wasn't like I walked in the store and was like, hey, I'm pretty dope with butt plugs. Can you point me to the spot where you guys keep the fucking. Yeah, so.
Oh my god, you're me with a dick.
Yeah, no, and the girl who did it to me was there that day when we were talking about it.
Yeah, she was in studio.
And she was a Broncos cheerleader.
Right on. Yeah. Doesn't it make it better? I wore a Broncos jersey, but I'm wearing my Ray Rice jersey instead.
Good for you. People forget. You know what I mean?
You and Rice go way back.
We do.
Are we going to talk about that today?
Concussion. Yes, we can totally talk about
that. You can be a white cop and punch a handcuffed person in the face. But Ray Rice can't hit his wife?
I mean, didn't she hear him the first time?
I think domestic abuse is shitty, but
that's
like...
That's a good question, man. That's a valid question to ask.
It's infuriates me. Like,
I knew we were going to get on lines that are going to get me in trouble.
I just said what she didn't hear it the first time, so who said it? I said it. Right, it was the girl. Yeah. You know I didn't mean it. I don't condone it. It's Purple Week. Everybody's against
it. Is it Purple Week?
Yes, so say we're against
it. Who comes up with these stupid fucking weeks?
Just say you're against it and go purple.
No, but like not to toe the line of being inappropriate and saying something for comic relief of like, oh yeah, sometimes bitches deserve to get punched and all that. Okay, hitting a girl is just, it's weak, right?
Yeah, just...
But like in America, a white cop can shoot a guy in the face 6 times. Or let's not even use race. We could YouTube right now women in handcuffs being punched by police and find 3,000 videos.
Yeah.
And those cops get a paid day off.
Those cops hadn't fucked them yet, so it's not domestic abuse.
It's different. It's a different line.
There has to be.
He didn't put a ring on it. So,
no. You know. Other than that, I think it's just assault, right?
Speaking of YouTube, since you guys are just meeting.
Oh, you got to see the video.
You guys are just meeting.
Oh, the video.
Dude, yeah. What video?
Chris.
Video.
Single moms.
I'm a huge fan, dude. I think this thing is genius, dude.
It's a good video.
You got to watch this.
All right. All right,
you ready?
Okay.
All right, here you go.
I haven't had sex in like 6 months.
Oh, yeah. Having kids is the best way to never get touched.
Mom, I need some $5.
Yeah. And that is why.
I know. I got a gym membership just for the daycare.
Why do you guys just do what I do? When I bring a guy home, I put them in front of the TV, turn the volume way up, and they can't hear a thing.
Whatever, bro. Just take your coffee.
Thanks, dude.
I'm about to shatter a cultural norm. You guys are so misinformed about the art form, creating a controversial shitstorm. For too long, sex has just been lukewarm. So I'm about to drop this bomb. I prefer to have sex with single moms. She was drunk at Chuck E. Cheese, and I didn't even have to say please. Before she passed me the keys and gave it up with ease. Now we're back at the crib. I watched her as she lied to her kid.
Mama's gotta get her hair tell him what you want, bitch. I don't give a shit.
The first time it was weird. It was the unknown, unknown that I feared. But that soon disappeared
when she turned around and cheered.
Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
I need a grilled cheese with the crust cut off.
Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
Keep your kid away, he's got whooping cough. Make me a snack, make me a snack.
Hey,
make me a snack, make me a snack.
Cut,
make me a snack, make me a snack. Make me a snack, make me a snack. Thought I had to take the walk of shame. Hi, I'm Uncle Chris, and what's your name? I know your daddy's gone, but I'm not to blame. Maybe one day we can catch a ball game. She took me home in her minivan. I sat in back with her little man. It was cool though, watching Finding Nemo. It's a round sound, black and tan in my hand.
She's not worried about the things that I did. It's cool though, cause her marriage came undid. She don't wanna deal with another kid.
Teddy grams after sex are quite splendid.
Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
I'm a grown man and my needs have changed.
Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
When the sex is over, I need food arranged.
Make me a snack, make me a snack.
PBJ.
Make me a snack, make me a snack.
Tuna melt.
Make me a snack, make me a snack.
Cinnamon bun.
Make me a snack, make me a snack.
Single moms, you're the best. I'm glad we're putting this controversy to rest. Because snacks after sex are the best. The way you treat us makes us feel so blessed. Cause you let me eat marinara sauce off your chest.
Chest,
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 chest.
Single,
so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
Had two kids, but you still stay fit.
Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom. Single, so single mom.
Why don't we make some banana splits?
Make me a snack, make me a snack. Make me a snack, make me a snack. Make me a snack. Make me a snack, make me a snack.
Okay, that was Single Moms by Chris Miller.
I loved it.
Do you want to talk about the story behind that video, Chris? Chris, we're over here.
What did you love about it?
What I loved about it is that
he's gonna masturbate
I have
to this
had three kids. I have three kids.
She didn't watch it.
And when I was a single mom, who doesn't love to hit a single mom? Plus, I would just go way younger in age, so it was always a win-win.
Yeah.
Younger yeah. guys can the single mom thing on that side is easier.
It's so easy because they're like, yeah, I just totally nailed a MILF and a radio MILF at that. Yeah. And I'm like, shit, just don't use my name.
You know, yeah, no, the story is I was on tour in Alabama and met the single mom after a show and she wanted to do it.
Yeah,
so I obliged. and she wanted to do it.
yeah.
So we did it. And
so we did it.
And the next morning, she, like one night stands, like, young people just go home, like, they go places.
Yeah, you
right?
don't get pancakes and shit.
Dude, this lady, like, took me to her home, and it was her ex-husband's, like, mansion, and I got, like, grilled cheese sandwiches and fucking, like, not just, like, a grilled cheese with love in it.
Like, three different cheeses and a parmesan
yeah,
crust.
Yeah, yeah. No, I've the crust was, there. Like, perfectly cut off, and one of them was, like, in the shape of a pterodactyl.
Hard.
And it was, like, and then she drove us around all day because the other comedian was with me, and then she was like, well, I could take you guys to the airport. You guys could just stay for a few days. And then I was like, my first question, no bullshit. I was like, well, do you have jet skis?
Seriously?
I always ask shit like that because that's yeah, going to be my Chris deciding factor.
100%.
If you got
I guarantee this is
entertainment toys
it's
for me to play with. 100%
true.
I'm in.
It was 100% true because I was like, well, if she's got like shit we can do,
yeah,
then we
like,
totally
like,
stay. And she was like, yeah, so we ended up staying for an extra day and like playing with all of
you're
her
like,
toys.
I can go home and fuck chicks, but if I stay here, do you have stuff I can do in my off time?
Right. In my downtime. Give
and
me
then
a couple hours in between.
On the way to the airport, I was literally watching like Disney films, like eating your kids' snacks.
Oh my God.
And I was like, this is the greatest.
Seriously, isn't it?
Girls in their 20s.
She drops you off. It's
well,
like,
it's like girls in their mid-20s, they still have that like, girls in your mid-20s, you still have this very like, you're on Facebook and dudes want to bang you and like you think you have a ton of options and so you're like you're kind of shitty with
dudes.
Well,
and like, what they're putting on Facebook are all the good times. They're not putting that they have a power bill outstanding of $900.
Right.
I'm not seeing that happy day checking right. in. Exhausted.
With mid-20-year-old girls, let's be realistic.
They do not...
there's competition.
As a 40-something person,
there's competition. Let me just tell you. Like, I'm vying for a 25-year-old girl's heart. That's completely hypothetical.
I hope so.
Yeah. No, but if I'm vying for a 25-year-old girl's heart, I've got to put in fucking work. Like, I'm buying dinners and taking her places and doing this and still on the hopes of maybe...
She doesn't even have any life skills yet.
Right, she doesn't.
But that's what I'm saying. But they don't even know what they're doing.
You take the pretty hot 40-year-old, recently divorced with two kids under 10, there's no fucking work involved.
Nurture.
All you have to do is show up. You're getting fed. You're getting... Clothes.
You just have to say hello when I walk in the fucking door and you're getting it. I mean, it's just a good day.
It's not the same. It's a hard fucking, like...
They have jobs.
But early 20s. Married to me versus fucking me, it's two completely different scenarios. Ask my husband and then ask my boyfriend.
I'm just going to stand over here quietly.
I mean, it is because I don't want to fuck... I'm not going to fuck my husband. That's completely out.
That sounds like... That sounds awful.
It doesn't work for me. Yeah. He works at a strip club. He sees tits and ass all day. I'm thinking, you saw it.
You gotta do the crazy stuff then for him.
I got nothing. He's completely like desensitized, and I don't want to do anything. I had a pull up.
Bring
for
another
a while
girl home. Bring another girl home.
I'm telling you, I think he's just too old and just. No, it's not happening.
Don't give up.
I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up. Marriage might be
unleash your mental titan.
I'm fine.
Unleash your mental titan, right?
Yeah.
MentalTitan.com.
Can I do a
second? I'm taking some course as we speak.
You're taking drugs as we speak?
It's all dark. You can't see.
Yeah,
they're all natural.
Oh, darn.
So do you exclusively now fuck up in age?
I exclusively really don't fuck.
Are you in a relationship now?
No.
A little bit?
No.
Nothing?
No.
You know why?
Do I know why?
Because nobody can stand you for more than like 4 hours.
No, it's terrible.
What do you mean? You sound like a blast in the glass.
No, I'm intense.
Here's the thing. Chris is the friend that you want to go out with on Friday night, but he has to go home Saturday.
Yeah.
And really only intense. Because you get like a Chris Miller hangover.
But I make grilled cheese.
I mean, I'll come over if that's what you're asking.
I mean,
will I have sex with you?
Out
yes.
There
yes.
Going out downtown with Chris is the funnest fucking thing in the world. You can plan on not getting home when you said you were, ending up in some weird fucking situation where there's like a midget and a guy on stilts.
Oh, so my husband's bar.
Right.
Lava.
I know her.
Yeah. We all know her.
And it'll be like 5 a.m.
Bridget
and you'll like you'll be walking out of like some weird back alley fight club / poker parlor, and like then you're like, fuck, dude, this has been a great night. I'm cashed. He's got eight more bars to go to. No, we just started.
Yeah.
Shit just got real.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, you get in a fight, you like your shirt is ripped.
And I gotta be honest, I wouldn't fuck with you if you said no, we're going somewhere else. I'd be like, okay.
Yeah, no, I'm a big guy.
You are. I've been you're a pretty big guy.
Been in a few fights.
Yeah.
I handle myself.
Okay. Yeah.
I mean, you're wearing pink, but you still.
That's because I can. Like, who would say?
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, no. I'm a big fan of Hemingway.
I have a quick question for you.
Mm-hmm.
About drugs?
Yeah.
I'm into them.
Is this logo trademarked for you?
Yes.
With the head?
Yeah.
Everything? I have an infringement case for you.
Why?
Okay.
Did you trademark that shit already?
No. I am in the process of rebranding from TrevorRocksDenver.com to Unfiltered.
Oh, it has nothing to do with my brand.
Kind of.
Yeah, it does have something to do with your brand.
It's actually a pretty interesting story.
You might want to listen at this point.
Yeah, you're
now it's time to stop talking.
Seriously.
Let the adults do
start
the talk.
Talking. And
so I'm in the process. I'm in the process of rebranding everything to Unfiltered and Unaffected because I've stepped away from the old brand and this is the new brand. This is where we're going. The website's up. I'm looking for a banner logo. So I put feelers out to like 75 different things looking for a logo.
Mm-hmm.
I went on Fiverr.com. You ever been to Fiverr.com?
Yeah, anything for $5. Yeah, I actually do some things on Fiverr. Go on.
That's the other side of Fiverr. Fiverr.com.
You haven't seen my Fiverr/Tracy Taylor?
You can go on there and find somebody to do anything in the world for $5.
For $5.
So there's all these graphic designers. And I just put out like 4 or 5 of them, paid $5, and they'll create a logo for you.
Right.
For $5. I'm like, if you'll do it for $5, I'll pay you $5. Even if it's shitty, I just know that it cost you more than $5 of your life.
Right.
So I win. So I get one back last night. I wish I could have sent this to you. I get this back last night, and I'm like, wow, this feels oddly, oddly, oddly familiar. The guy sends me...
your logo?
The guy sends me a logo to accept or ask for modifications on. And I was like, all right, I'll open it. I was half awake, half asleep. It doesn't make sense if you can't see it, but...
Let me see. Huh.
And you're asked to accept or make changes to said logo?
Yes.
But you have no copyright on it.
No. This is the guy on Fiverr created this logo, and he sends it to you initially and says, tell me if you want any modifications.
Hell.
Tell me if you like this logo or not. Yee. Tell me what's up. You know, if you want any slight changes, but this is kind of what I concepted for your logo.
Yeah, well, I'd like a slight change right here.
Uh-oh. Now, the logo for Koios is really cool. It's this head with like a swirl going through it and colors.
Does it look like a dish bag? Let me see.
Can we side by side them?
No, it's exactly the same.
It looks brain food-ish.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Yeah.
Now, what are the possible chances in the universe of how many billions of
Can
people
Can you send
are
that
there?
To me?
Yes, I will. How many billions of people there are
that
in
have
the world?
This logo?
Well, no. How many billions of people are there? How is it possible that Chris Miller and I do business together, and I ask a guy in England to create a logo for me?
AKA
Chris
India.
Chris owns a company who has a logo that's already trademarked. Get your camera and zoom in on this real quick if you can see my phone.
Holy balls. That is not even funny.
This is the fucking logo.
Wow, random.
Can you zoom in?
This is the logo that's sent to me.
Can you zoom in on that one?
They're both in.
I don't think you can see mine.
We can pull up his logo. Anyway, it's the exact
same they changed the colors.
Fucking head with different colors on it.
Pretty
now, what are the chances that he's going to send me that, and I happen to do business with the guy
that he ripped off?
That's
called the universe, and God is being nice to you, so thank her.
Thank her.
Could you imagine?
Her. Maybe he's just messing with you, man.
God's
could you
chick,
imagine
dude.
Had I not
you know?
Paid attention to what Chris's logo was, and I was like, yep, that's the fucking one, and I plastered it on the website?
I don't know. I think you'd have some copyright infringement problems with Chris.
Is this insane?
And his arms are a little bigger than yours.
I'm not scared of Chris.
It's hot.
I'm not scared of Chris. His balls are bigger than his dick, so I have no problem punching that area.
Oh my gosh, can I read you the best statistic ever I've read? Hold on, let me find
it. You have a statistic?
We're actually getting ready to go through a whole rebranding anyway.
Well, sue that asshole before you do it.
Is that fucked up?
That's not even worth it. It'd be worth it is... See, the only place where trademarks make... Because as you look into it, like, there's other companies called Koios, there's other... Where trademark infringement gets bad is like if you copied Red Bull, and it's basically the law is basically saying that if it infringes on someone's image or like you've,
right.
In our case, it
defamation.
Someone would look at it and go, really, you don't sell enough of this. It's not recognized enough.
It's not Pepsi.
No. That you they'd be like, go fuck yourself.
But you probably want to have that on file just in case.
No, you do, you do.
But had it gotten right now to the point of Pepsi.
That's like song copyright rights, you know. If you're pooping around Denver, you know, and you got a cool song and someone steals it, you're probably fucked.
Yeah, you should copyright everything you write. My wife's band, they copyright every song they write. They copyright it like the next day.
Like send it to themselves and
No. You can copyright blocks of songs of like 30 or 35 songs at a time under one single copyright, and then it's only one fee for all of those. But if you don't have copyright and I like the song, I could take it and record it at my house real quick and copyright it, and you lose the song completely.
Back to kicking in the balls.
Oh, okay.
Did you know that a kick in the balls is above 9,000 units of pain, which is similar to giving birth to 160 kids and breaking up to 3,200 bones at one time?
I'm going to disagree.
I'm going to say I love this news.
What is a unit?
I don't really know.
A
unit of pain?
But I've had three kids, and I'm going to tell you right now, if you can get an epidural for me to kick you in the balls, you might want to do that.
Here's the deal. I'm going to disagree wholeheartedly.
Because I don't have that junk. I
train in combat sports.
Oh, yeah. You're a good person, Adam.
I like how you said that.
I train in combat sports.
Combat sports.
More
bitch.
Often. It happens more often than you would ever believe. In the last year, I've probably been kicked, need rolled into in my nuts probably 30 times.
Wow.
It hurts. And it hurts.
It's debilitating.
It's not that bad, though.
You can get nicked in the nuts and be
fucked. It'll give you a stomach ache. And then you're like, ah. But within a couple minutes, I've recovered and I can continue to train. I've seen childbirth 4 times.
It's not the same.
That shit is way more painful. Okay, I mean, just the...
Thank you for this. I needed this.
The empathy that I feel while I'm watching childbirth hurts more than getting kicked in the nuts and I'm not even feeling childbirth.
Right. Well, I, in all theory, should think you should be getting kicked in the nuts while I'm giving birth.
We're no longer friends.
Just to make it fucking fair.
We're no longer
just
friends.
Just to keep it level. Keep it real.
We did our part.
You know what? No longer breeding, just consulting.
We got the biscuit past the basket. You guys deal with it after that.
The biscuit.
That is so true. And thank you for the baby gravy if we're going to have to go all food weird.
Gravy.
Sitting in Studio B hanging out, probably scared to fucking death to walk into the studio right now because it was nothing that she was ready for, I'm sure. Monika Leigh, come on over and join us. Come. You might as well have that uncomfortable look on your face on camera. You can leave your guitar. We're going to go over there.
All right.
And you'll sing over there. Monika, this is Chris Miller. He is
Hi.
A
Monika.
Scary
as
he was a touring
scary.
Comedian.
Scary as hell. Oh, you're a comedian.
He was a touring comedian. He's also a huge entrepreneur. He's the guy that created Koyos, the brain food that I take that makes me somewhat intelligent some days.
He's talking somewhat a lot. Smart.
But it's good. Yeah, I'm going like 100 miles a fucking hour.
At least he's not doing the robot.
He had like the monster and the
I had Koyos, coffee, a monster, and a Koyos this morning. Just so everybody knows that. Exactly where I'm at. This is our first endeavor with Tracy and I as partners, so we've stepped all over each other 100 times, so it's not going to stop now.
I doubt
it's
it.
It's working no. great, guys.
Yeah, are you feeling
it's
it, Chris?
Actually, it's
yeah.
kind of like we're married already. Every partner
so
that
you
I've
have
ever
a
had.
Husband, a boyfriend, and now a on
studio.
I have an on studio, no. on screen
Correct.
Lover.
Yeah. Gay no, partner.
I'm not making
gay
any
lover.
Money yeah. from this.
Nice.
No afternoon delight. Afternoon delight. Afternoon delight. That's good. Yeah, afternoon delight.
We're in the morning, though.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
So, Monika, I will be completely honest. I used to be obsessed with The Voice, and then I've taken a break from it a little bit here and there, and I catch it now and then. Chris hit me up on a message. He's like, hey.
I know you.
Do you want a high yeah. five?
Well, no, but I'm freaking out for a second. Hold on. Can we
you guys should high
five. You
want
a high five?
Chris sends me
a high five. Oh my gosh.
Chris
okay.
sends me a message on Facebook and he's like, do you have a musical guest for this week? And it was 2 weeks ago. And I was like, yeah, I'm booked for this week. He's like, do you want to have Monika Leigh on? And I was like,
who the hell is that?
Monika Leigh. Yeah, send me something, Chris. I maybe, probably, I don't know. Are they musical?
They didn't ask me.
Okay. And then he sends over.
God, I'm a voice stalker. I'm a voice stalker.
And then he sends over the clip of you on The Voice. And I was like, why did you fucking even ask me, you idiot? Schedule that. Get it booked. I just hadn't put the name with the... I mean, you know how it is. People walk up to you, you know Tom Smith, and you're like...
Sure.
Twice.
Yeah. Always say nice, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Tom.
2 times.
Great guy,
Tom. 1:30 minutes ago.
And then when it all connected, I was like, why would you even fucking ask? You just book that shit.
Yeah.
And we'll bump Matt McChesney again.
Wait,
for
where's
you.
Matt? Where's Matt?
Has Matt...
Hold on, is Matt here?
Matt? Chirp, chirp, chirp. Is that the cricket?
He didn't have the cue ready.
Ah!
So Matt McChesney, former Denver Bronco, owner of 6-0 Fitness, has been scheduled for the last 3 weeks on the show.
Oh.
So we're just going to perpetually schedule him for the rest of our lives.
Every week, because I think he's going to show up sometime.
At some point, he's going to be here.
I think that's the best plan that you could do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's
I mean,
awesome.
We're going to leave tickets for Elvis and Matt McChesney, and hopefully one of them.
Mm-hmm. And Tupac?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Good luck, guys.
I won't go there again. I won't do it again. I'm sorry.
Tracy.
West Coast, bitches. Oh West Coast.
You can't get off your phone, Chris Miller.
You can't do Tupac.
Sorry.
I can't do Sorry. Tupac. He's on the Elvis Island.
It's the pills he took. He's
you
like,
can
his
fuck
mind
up.
Too focused.
You can fuck up
focused.
With Elvis people now because they're old enough that we could push them down and break their hip.
Steph Bailey was messaging
Steph
me.
Bailey.
Yeah.
Do you know Steph?
It's that old chestnut, you know.
Is this Steph, that? Are we back to the anal thing? Because
nice.
I can't go
Steph
there.
Steph is my assistant.
I appreciate that.
And then I work
they got
for
my
her.
This week, too. Isn't that
yeah. I work for Steph at my day job, and then she's my assistant
How does that work for you?
The other time.
I
kind of so
like it.
Weird why she's messaging him.
Okay, well, she
I'm
likes
pretty,
him.
Like, alpha yeah. testosterone guy, too. Like,
yeah.
What the fuck?
We're having our own conversation.
What's going on?
We're having our own conversation.
I told her she smells good. Did you see what just happened there? She smells good, he said. I said, you guys got my shower.
No, you got me all rattled with this logo because we're already changing it, but now I really want to change it.
Oh, thanks for fucking up the show and making his brain fucked.
Yeah,
it was
funny and fun. No, I was.
Yeah, he was fun, Chris. Now he's weird.
She smells great.
He's what? Thanks.
Don't.
He's a toucher. He's fucking. Yeah.
Yeah.
I am so on the side of the couch. Look out.
Don't fight it.
She missed the butt plug conversation, so.
No.
Do you want to rehear the butt plug conversation?
Okay.
Rehear.
I was like, you smell great. And then she said, I shower. And I was like, you know, recently I've decided to stop showering for like 4 or 5 days at a time.
I said you're
when you're writing, do you stay at home and not shower sometimes?
Oh, yeah, no, but I'll, like, work out and, like...
Okay. Yeah, I'd be a dude.
What?
Do you write?
Yeah.
Chris rides, too.
I wrote a film last year. I'm working on a book.
Do I write?
Yeah. Ride.
Oh, ride. Motorcycle.
Oh, ride.
Are you kidding me?
No, he was writing.
Oh, what do you write? What do you, like, a...
Why did you say it like that?
Dear diary. What do you write?
Words?
Dear diary. Words that are emojis? Oh, my God. I just
like, if she was like, I do music, I'd be like, why?
I've written 2 books.
I put out a movie last year that got optioned. I'm working on a book right now. Jokes from time to time.
You got jokes?
Yes, maybe.
He's a comedian, sort of.
He's got jokes.
That's like when someone's like, I'm a musician. And it's like, play me a song right now.
Right.
Just start singing.
Hey, funny guy, tell me a fucking Hey, funny guy, tell me a joke.
Yeah,
or like
when
you're
a
comedian, this thing always happens. You'll be like in a cab, and you'll be like, oh, yeah, I'm doing a show at the Gotham or whatever. And some the cab will be like, Okay. I got one. You can keep this. Yeah. You can.
It's all yours,
baby. Does he say you can keep this for your little
show? Just keep this for. Use it tonight if you want. Just. Okay. So there's this guy, right? And wait, it's a girl. This girl. And it's like 10 minutes of just shitty.
Set up is 10 minutes.
And you're just like, dude, okay. You're excited.
That's always fun.
Yeah. Have you ever gotten
being
anything
in radio
good?
When you get into the cabs, they're like, do you have concert tickets?
You're right here in my pocket.
No, yeah.
Yeah. No, they're never good.
They actually gave me a folder full of concert tickets just to walk around with today.
Like, big cabbies with.
Steph, if you're still listening to the show, I'll just get you another bottle to Trevor and sure order got messed up.
What'd she say?
Steph, stop texting.
What'd she say?
I'm going to be the girl right now to step back in the middle of this.
I am next to him.
Did I take her bottle?
So, before...
Did you have donuts this morning?
No. Did you?
Yes.
Why wouldn't you?
Why did you not bring voodoo?
Well, I was just like gonna say, why didn't you bring donuts?
They smell nice. Like it's cookies.
Like cookies.
Are you married?
It's no.
Do you have kids? My God, no. This is happening.
Did you see what Chris is putting in?
Okay.
You feel uncomfortable? Are you sweaty?
No, not yet.
I'm sweaty.
You want to hear the butt plug conversation?
Yeah, actually, I do. That does sound actually.
How about you get really that guitar out and see what we're talking about with the voice? How do we do that? How's that Blake Shelton?
How do we go from butt plug? I don't know. To Blake Shelton and singing. That's
okay. The original conversation.
That's obvious.
Hello.
The original conversation that was supposed to be.
I know, Blake.
Is yes, mm-mm. It's Chris over here. Over here. Sparkly stuff. We were talking about the iPhone. iPhone 6 was released today. We were talking about what we would stand in line for. Tracy and I both agree that we don't stand in line
for anything except for Disneyland because they make you. I don't want 2 new friends on either side of me an hour and a half later with phone numbers exchanged from Chicago and fucking England.
I would stand in line for like 4 really hot girls all at the same time.
Really?
That's about it.
That's it?
A fivesome?
And to meet Jesus.
Oh, well.
And.
Yeah, probably the Pope. I'd probably stand in line for the Pope.
No.
I stood in line to get in the Vatican for a few minutes.
How many minutes?
You can get a VIP pass at the Vatican.
Okay, cool.
You can buy the express pass?
Yeah, no.
You can buy. Of course you can buy the express pass.
It is like Disneyland. You just go and get an express pass.
Sure, $15 and you're out.
Of course at the Vatican you can pay to upgrade.
Why would you? Same at the White House. You could fast pass your way right in.
Stand in line to see my new friend sing.
Oh, I know. I'd like to hear that.
Monica, what would you stand in line for?
Disney World.
Because you have to. Am I right?
Correct.
Because they no longer
allow They do have the fast pass.
We already said that. You know, that's like,
that's the truth.
That's like saying world peace, you know? Like, but what would you really stand in line for?
Okay.
True.
I'm trying to think.
Would you stand in line for an Apple phone?
Fuck no.
Never.
No.
You couldn't pay me. Would you stand in line to see this guy?
I'd stand in line to punch a terrorist in the face.
Okay. All right, going to okay. terrorists.
If that was an option.
Now we're into water.
I love this show. This show is fun.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
I'd stand in line to waterboard someone.
If you terrorist.
Whoa. Yeah. Just like a normal person?
Well, I mean, that whole husband thing I was discussing earlier. I think we probably do some work.
Okay. Chris is actually really... He's up to date, and he's really well-read. He's pretty intelligent guy. And I don't want to say these things, but he is.
I assume my IQ is like 160.
I don't care.
Did you see how impressed we just got?
What's your dick size?
Shit, my nipples just got hard. Could you see him through my Ray Rice?
I would let you know, but you're good.
Yeah, good.
ISIS is now the big terrorist that we're after, ISIS. Aren't they the same fucking terrorists? We just rename them every couple years?
If you were a terrorist group, wouldn't you name your group something way cooler than ISIS?
But I would name this IKEA, and I would have everyone go there.
Come on, ISIS. Really?
Aren't they the same fucking terrorists? That we just call them something different depending on the president or what needs press at the time? Because I have a feeling they all look exactly the same. They all come from the same area. Aren't they the same? Aren't they the same fucking terrorists?
What you mean, you people?
Oh, God, here we go.
Yeah.
You people.
We're going to tiptoe the terrorism. Line of race.
Jessica won't even come
How
in the room anymore.
How about we just erase it? No,
are they the
mean,
same people? I think so. It's manufactured hate.
It is. They're teaching them to kill at 2 years old. They're walking around with machine guns.
But they're all the same people, right?
Kind of.
In
no,
the
I
same
mean, they
village,
have different.
Maybe I'll say. I don't
some
know.
Some of those guys have different doctrine and like different like ideas, and their some of their core beliefs are different. It's almost like saying our Baptists the same as Christians.
They're the same.
Non-denominational. They're not. They have different.
Right.
They have different, like.
They're the same. They all point and judge.
Kind of. It's like.
They all point and judge.
It's like saying.
Same fucking people.
Baptists way less point and judge.
Same
it's
people.
Like, it's like grouping. It's almost like grouping comedians together. Like, in music, you have. If you do country versus hip hop, you're still a musician, right? But you're doing a different type of music. So I think some of those guys have very different, like.
What's the big difference?
I like that he
just made a comparison, though, to terrorists and music.
And music.
That's,
it's pretty similar.
They got it into it to
it's
radio.
It's kind of the same thing.
Cultist.
Yeah, I mean,
it's very cultist.
Yeah. Followers.
But no, it's a lot of it's manufactured hate. Like, it's just...
Maybe.
It's,
Twitter terrorists.
Twitter...
They have followers.
What?
More than you.
Twitter.
Which sucks.
Wow.
Hey, did you just throw a bottle of water on the ground?
Yeah, an epiphany.
Wait,
and it bounced. That's how talented
really... Really crazy. Whoa, back it up.
Sorry.
So, terrorists on Twitter.
No, Twitter is terrorism.
Oh. Okay.
Because they have followers.
Oh.
Like a fucking jihad.
Okay.
People do whatever the fuck.
I was thinking that I could go follow a terrorist on Twitter as well.
I'm sure there's got to be a terrorist with a Twitter.
I mean, you should try it and see if it actually has anything like that.
I need to verify it. I'm not following it.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Usain Ubabi. I'm not fucking following it.
How are you not? You're not even a real fucking terrorist. And I've been following you for 6 months.
That's rad.
And you're a chick eating a Kentucky Fried Chicken. Oh, my God.
They do have Twitter accounts.
Have you already looked into this?
It's pretty common knowledge.
It's common knowledge?
Yeah.
I know that he's way more common knowledge than we are.
God, apparently. Maybe I'm not with it.
I don't have a lot of friends. I spend a lot of time
with him. Yeah, he's very smart. I'm not.
Don't have a lot.
IQ of 160.
At least this guy.
So Disneyland, we've decided.
Like round down.
We've decided the only three things we'll stand in line for. Punch a terrorist, go to Disneyland, and visit
and meet
the Vatican.
That Bronco who's supposed to show up every fucking week.
Ladies and gentlemen, Matt McChesney.
Is he here?
You didn't see him?
He's over here by the intern.
Maybe next week.
No, if there was a I'd stand in line for like a really crazy sexual thing, probably. Like if it was like all the hottest girls I've ever wanted to sleep with, and they were like, you have to stand in line for a few days, I'm like, okay.
You would stand in line for a few
days? You would camp out for sex.
If it was like all the hottest girls I've ever wanted
like
to be
like Jenna Jameson pre-ugly porn, like good porn.
Megan Fox.
Yeah, dude, come on.
Alyssa Milano before the kids.
Whatever you want to keep cold. Like whoever you're into.
Whatever's
in your spank bank, leave it there. Don't put it out on the rest of us.
Yeah, but
fuck,
if they
not
were like,
to
yeah,
Alyssa
you get Jessica Alba, Megan Fox, Kate Upton. Yeah, and they were like, they're all in the same room.
Could this bottle be louder?
You can do it. Just whatever your imagination can conceive.
So
and
the
how many people are in line in front of you for those days that you're waiting to fuck Kate Upton?
That wasn't part of the original plan.
Don't fuck up his dream.
Oh. Okay, I didn't know.
Just
didn't know.
You.
It's a valid question, though.
I was just wondering.
Because waiting in line.
He said for days, not hours.
It can't be you just waiting by yourself in line. You have to deal with the fucking crazy that is waiting in line.
Well, that's what I mean, is that I get, when we're in Disneyland, my mom becomes best friends with the lady to the next right of us, and my kids are best friends with the kids, and now we're all riding rides together. I didn't need new fucking friends at Disneyland.
Wait, hold on. I would respectfully disagree with that. Don't you think, though, that in life, this is going to get a little philosophical. This guy asked me the other day, I have a mentor, right, and he's made...
You need more mentors.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't matter how much money he's made, but he's uber wealthy, right?
Right.
And he goes, I spent this part of my life doing X. And then he goes, after this, I came out of this thing and I was asking myself this question, what if I only had 6 months to live? And it fucked me up.
That's Life Coach 101, isn't it?
No, it's not though. Because Life Coach 101 goes, be positive and get up and do shit and fuck.
You've read every self-help book
in the
world.
I have. So
you just come over and get me out of bed every day?
You take this concept of like 6 months, okay, right? And I started thinking about it for like weeks and I was like, if I only had 6 months, what do you do, right? And the initial response most people go is like, oh, I'd fucking do this thing. I've always wanted to go to Vegas. But like, I'm going back to your point, and it's little shit that I think would change, which is like, I'm riding my bike the other day, which I do a lot more now, which I think a lot of people should try, because it makes you slow down and like look
unless
at shit.
Unless you can't ride a bike.
Unless you're crippled, then yeah, you're fucked.
Well, I'm used to the stationary bike because
so like I'm riding my bike
fucks me up.
And I'm thinking of this concept of 6 months, right? And I see these little kids and they have this lemonade stand, and I blow right by it, and they look like they're having fun, and their friends are out, and like they're these adults. And I was like, if I only had 6 months to live, I would stop and buy that lemonade and make friends and like probably spend the afternoon building a fort and like. You would,
oh
you would
God,
engage.
Cry. Who are you?
You would engage.
Just from the biggest crazy person to like, I have chills.
You would engage with these people and be human. And I think like your point of being in line with people, I think if we were more open to the idea of just like being human, I don't even like
that's, you know what? That's true. That's true. And it's not because I came away with friends from Disneyland, but I have met a lot of people in weird situations like that, where you are thrown together in a socially awkward standing in line situation.
Like we're all friends now.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Mostly
you guys know
because we've been in an awkward situation together.
But not in a line.
See, now I look at it completely differently, Chris.
Lines.
And that's only because I'm,
trust me,
biggest
narcissist like
in the entire fucking world.
I don't like
world.
People that much
no, that
either.
Is such a good point.
But I wish
I would have problems doing the lemonade stand because my minutes would have value that they would have to equate to. Like, is that lemonade stand worth the 4 minutes that I'm going to spend on it because I've only got this many minutes
left? It's not
left.
The lemonade stand. It's the connection with
I'm
those
just
people.
Saying. Yeah, it is. But I think like being, I don't know, at least in radio and getting paid for appearances and, you know, going out and standing at Safeway for 2 hours and then paying me $300 to stand at a Safeway. I'll be fake nice to any bitch that
that's
walks up
awesome.
To me.
That's
awesome. Hey, best job I've ever had.
Chad Drew is next door and he wants to know if he can stop by. Can you message him and tell him he can stop by only if he brings presents for people in the studio?
Who's Chad Drew?
Is he the help motel owner? Because I don't want any presents
no.
from over there.
Chad Drew is the assistant manager and our customer representative for one of our station sponsors, Evergreen Apothecary.
Oh, I love him. Bring him. He can come.
Yeah, he's cool.
Treats. Right.
Speaking
edibles,
of Evergreen Apothecary.
Tequila.
They don't sell tequila there, but we can have an intern.
Are you really on The Voice?
No, that's a lie.
Can we show that, Trevor? Or is NBC going to...
Well, it should be fine.
All right.
Don't mock me.
You want to see it real quick?
Yeah. Hold on.
Texas, you devil.
Just watch the screen.
What?
Well, let me cue it up first.
Did you just ask me if we can play it and you don't even have it fucking ready?
Well, come on, dude.
He wanted
that's
to make
exciting,
sure that
dude.
You were
I didn't even know if it was...
Yeah, it's good for you.
I didn't even know we could do it, man.
I don't think he wanted you to get by NBC
sweet.
Today.
I'm going to stand in line.
P.S. I got chicken wing
wasted. To kick Chris in the balls.
You ever got chicken wing wasted? You gotta get over and can't eat chicken wings.
I love chicken
wings.
Oh,
that's me. The thrill is gone. The thrill is gone away. The thrill is gone, baby. The thrill is gone away.
Yeah, come on. You know you want it, Blake. Turn around.
You know you've done me wrong, baby. You'll be sorry someday.
Thank you.
Oh my god, standing from Adam!
I should have picked him. I regret it.
You didn't pick Adam? Woo. You picked Blake.
I knew it.
Oh my god, you're beautiful! What is your name, beautiful?
My
name
is so Monika
Leigh. I can't
you're
believe you're hedging
your bets,
weren't
you?
You're
hedging your bets!
Being country is
I mean, these guys are gonna have.
Kind of, yeah.
No, she was hedging her bets because he's
the
fun the fucking
game. That is what I was like, I'm gonna.
If he turns around, I'm taking.
I want to build my team around this girl. Well, I want to build my team around her too.
Do it, Adam. Come on.
You just called the voice, and that's why I turned around. It just seemed really pure. It's hard to sing that way.
I was in starstruck of Christina, honestly, because
that's
one of those
like.
Well, and if you remember, and not to bash or anything, I think she's wonderful. But the last time that I saw her was on People Magazine, and she was big. She's huge, and there was all this rumor of her losing all this weight, but I hadn't seen it. And then when she turned around, and she's like super tiny, I felt kind of like a bitch because I was like. But I was like, that's so rude that I'm doing this right now.
No,
so I was like, you're beautiful. But she is. I mean, she's this larger than life.
Yeah, but you're her being big.
I'm not
going to
love you any less ever.
Well,
that's great. Well, maybe y'all can
go out on a date.
From the magazines, do you remember seeing that though?
I
like,
do.
All those. She was pretty thick. And not that was bad. I mean, she wore it well.
Do we all kill ourselves?
All the elements of just being.
Sorry.
And then I just fell in love with your voice. It's the same thing that would make me want to turn my stereo up if you came on the radio. There's just something that you have.
Yeah, you know what? You reminded me of my friend Jana. And so
that's
I don't know what
it wasn't even a matter of technique.
Is she cool? Is she good?
I can give you three reasons why you should pick me.
Oh my god.
She's that good?
She's labeled good.
Like
on tour good.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, then I love her.
I'm going
Jana Kramer, you don't know Jana?
Yeah.
She used to be on One Tree Hill. You look great. You look all right.
You have a doppelganger.
You have a doppelganger.
I'll take it.
Like I'm not very country.
Do you have a doppelganger?
Can I respond to this?
Diana.
No, you cannot. Stop talking, man.
Do you have
put
a doppelganger?
No,
I got medicine.
I've only won this show.
No, I'll tell you who his doppelganger is.
Or Mike's life.
I won with an R&B guy. I won with a rock girl, Cassidy Pope. And I won with Daniel Bradbury. One country artist.
What are you thinking? Who do you pick as your coach?
okay.
So that's pretty cool, huh?
Like that. All right.
So enough
just
about me.
Listen to her, okay?
Let's talk about you.
Just
let's
take
it.
The compliments and
it.
Just take it.
What do I think about you? You want me to be honest?
No, I don't.
I'm
scared
I do.
Where this might go.
All right, are we back?
He's going towards cupcakes.
And welcome back to the show. Wow, I think the mics were live for a lot of that, which is awesome. Which is awesome. We talked about Christina Aguilera being a fat-ass bitch.
The mics were live for that? I
swear. Are you writing down tags over here, sweetheart?
I just feel a little uncomfortable, Kurt.
Chris and I listened to the conversation and had no idea what they were talking about for the most part.
But we can talk about Jessica Simpson. How do you get the Weight Watchers out when you have a second baby?
Hold on a second. You're on the fucking... What happened? Like, who are you? What's the deal?
Tell us the story. Is that what you want?
Yeah, like, what... This is cool.
Chris, look how intrigued he is.
I know. I don't think you're intrigued by anything.
This is a big deal?
You just got a fame boner right there.
No, because I get it from like an artist's perspective. Like, I've done enough traveling and comedy and been on enough stages. If you get on Last Comic Standing and you crush and you do good, that's fucking a big deal.
Oh, my God. Who would?
When you get three to turn around on The Voice on TV.
When I get on Teen Mom 2, it's fucking a bit.
You did well in life.
I had like six kids.
Okay, so break it down for those of us who live in a closet and didn't watch The Voice.
So I was fortunate enough to get onto the stage to audition for the coaches, four coaches. They have your back to you, so they don't see you. It's just based on your voice. But to get there, you have to go through a shit ton of auditions to begin with. I'm sure like any other competition show or whatever. So I get on there, and I had three chairs turn, which meant I'm on. And I went through two other competitions, and then I got knocked off by this amazing chick named Kat, who I love hate. I love her because she's a badass, and I hate her because she kicked me off.
I really remember Kat.
You don't really like her, right?
Oh, I do actually, but that's the problem.
Like, don't you hate that being a girl?
See, being a girl, you guys can do that and still like them. We just fucking hate you when we want to punch you in the face.
I wish I could hate her, but I can't. I can't.
They're probably cycling together. That's why they like each other.
The greatest thing about her, and this was the funniest thing, too, because she went on before me, and she sang Alanis Morissette, and she's, like, punching the air and kicking, and, like, she, like, spread eagles on the ground and, like, lays back. And
were you in the back just like,
yes,
really?
I really was.
You ought to know.
And you, yes, and you can see me, and you can see me sitting there, and I'm like, oh, I'm like, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. And then I get on, and I'm like, what can I do to top it? And I'm like, a hair flip. I'll do a hair flip. So, like, I
totally would have done it with my pants off.
So you...
I channeled Beyonce and I did a full on like head swing.
Oh, good. No fan? And, no fan?
I wish. I should have just been walking around going like this. And
dude, I want
something.
A portable fan. Like,
so you can always have the hair blown?
Geico saves me insurance. I want a fan, baby. Follow me around.
See, but I'm such a child, though. If I had a fan following me around, I would just make Darth Vader noises.
Yes.
Yeah, no, I'd be Beyonce and everything. Looks like, no freaking thing.
Looks like you have a fan that's going to follow you around.
Yeah. Oh. Stalky eyes just got on Stalky.
Blow my cup.
I love this show.
Let's go there. After the show, were there a lot of fucking creepers? Was it weird?
There are a few, yeah.
Like Facebook, Twitter, like all of a sudden?
I actually got a few death threats on Twitter.
How do you get death threats?
What?
Man, for singing?
Well, I made a comment directly.
Did you have a pageant moment?
No, not even. It was actually kind of...
That's been me four times.
I said something about Christina... kind of commenting about her being a diva, but it wasn't a negative connotation. I mean, if you think about it, she worked really hard for that.
You
title.
Were saying like
she is a diva,
diva that you look up to,
but Mariah, diva.
Well, that's what I mean. Like it wasn't meant to be like this diva bitch. Not at all. And all of a sudden, people were like coming at
they
me.
They thought
at
you were a Christina
man,
hater.
Oh man, like. Big, I hope you die, and you didn't deserve to be on that stage with her. And like, it got crazy. It got really, really crazy.
That's like doubly bad when it's a super fan of a celebrity now wants to kill you because they think that you don't. Not just like the super fan that became a super fan of you that's like, I love you. We should be together.
Right. Which I also had.
Don't you love those guys?
No in between. It was just very heavy.
Chris wanted to come in to apologize.
He's down on one knee. I don't know why.
I'll take it. Let's go now.
I don't like you anymore now. It's got to be a struggle. It's got to be like...
If there's no chase...
He gave up too early!
If there's no chase, he doesn't want to do it.
Yeah, I'm out.
Like, you have to be...
And he's not going to put a ring on unless it's an anal ring.
He has to be chasing you at all times.
He's a good guy, I swear.
Ish. So
admittedly, no.
It was either one extreme or the other.
Correct. No, in between.
Yeah. Nobody was like, hey, I saw you in The Voice. Good job. And then they were gone. They were like, I saw you in The Voice.
Yeah, I mean, of course, friends
puts the lotion on its skin.
Right.
Or it gets the hose again. I gotta pee.
He broke the seal in the middle of the show.
Chris is that guy. He does that.
He does that?
Yeah, he just leaves.
It's the pills. Maybe it's the pills.
I don't want any part of those pills.
No. Tracy's actually had pretty weirdo fucking creepy stalkers.
Yeah, radio gives you the... Because they think you're speaking directly to them every night for 5 hours. Of course. When I'm giving the weather, Barry thinks that I'm speaking to him about the weather.
Right.
Sure.
Barry thinks I'm dedicating a song to him when I say, here's Taylor Swift. And Barry followed me to the Grizzly Rose one night, and they had to... He grabbed my arm, and he goes, do you know who I am? I emceed, like, Gary Allen or somebody, and I came off stage, and he said, I go, no, and he's like, I'm Barry, and I just went, nice to meet you, and I kind of just kept walking and grabbed my arm away, and I'm like, this guy over here has been sending me letters. They have a file at the station, because I have a file at every station for numerous things, but the stalker
file. The other file.
Well, there's a few files. The sued file, the stalker file, and then you're in big trouble. Yeah, and but there's so many people like that. On Valentine's Day one year, some guy was in the parking lot when I got off my shift with a ring to propose.
Did you take the ring?
No, I asked him what his fucking name was and to get the fuck out of the parking lot. It was an unsecure parking lot. Like, you don't
leave. Is it bad, though? Like, my first reaction would have been, yoink, and then started running?
No, that would have been a reaction, well, except for
gotta pay the rent.
Yeah, you do, but A, I'm questioning your cubic zirconia, because if you're down on one and I see your Dodge Beater or whatever it is, and the, you know, your whatever minivan with holes in it. But there was this family that would stalk me, and they'd stalk all the way from Longmont, which you know is a hell of a drive.
Longmont!
They would drive, and they would sit behind the KYGO studio windows, and they would call me on the phone, and I'd answer, hi, KYGO. And they'd say, turn around. And I'd turn around, and they'd flash their headlights.
Any conversation that starts with turn around.
Like, well, there's a window behind me, and so, you know, that's never good. So I'm like, turning around, I look out the window, and they've got, it's like 10 o'clock at night, they've got their kids all jammied up and shit in the car. So they knew I got my coffee at a certain Safeway, way down in Denver. So they went there, did their Thanksgiving shopping at that Safeway. Just right around the time I happened to get my coffee.
I just happened to be.
There's no Safeway in Longmont from here to Longmont.
It's all weird. Like, hey, we got turkeys. Do you like turkeys?
I mean, you like turkeys.
At least they weren't offering you children. Take my daughter. This is for you.
Yeah, well, no, I probably would have.
Oh God!
Wait, so I have a thing. I want to save polygamy kids, the little polyg kids, but that's a whole nother show. No, it is.
Don't deadlock with me.
You can take the Amish. Yeah, I got the plugs, okay?
Wait, what's your name again?
Stephanie.
So, after the voice, what are you doing? You're doing gigs and stuff now?
Yeah, Nicole's busy doing gigs.
Yeah.
Nicole?
Yeah.
Stephanie.
Jessica, it's okay. Just call me
Jessica.
Here. Amber, where are you playing next?
So, my name is Megan. No, it's Monica. I'm going to be playing here at Herman's Hideaway on next Saturday, the 27th.
So I have a question. As an artist, like, when you go from The Voice, to, like, Herman's Hideaway, how do you deal with, like, the ups and downs of... Because I was thinking about that the other night as, like, a comic. You could do, like, you'll do, like, this big show and just crush, and then the next three nights you're at, like, Lion's Lair, and people are like, fucking, I hate this guy. And it's like this depressing, like, up and down of...
Yeah, sure, I could see that. I mean, honestly, I don't look at it like that. I'm just happy to play. I play on the street all the time. Oh, see, here we go. He's like...
I love it. She's got her guitar case open. She's true. Not throwing the dollars at you. You better put them in her guitar. Yeah.
maybe comedy's different because it's so based on, like, the reaction.
But that's what I'm saying. You're doing it to get a laugh out of people, right? Like, you have a goal is to make people laugh. For me...
I mean, if you're being altruistic, like, the goal is to be up there talking and being creative.
Okay.
And I wrote
and
this
not making
thing,
people laugh?
No, but the end goal, yeah, is to bring joy and happiness and make people
well,
laugh.
Well, and right. I think the end goal is, and speaking from radio, is that we get an external, like, almost high off of it. Like, it's an external validation,
sure.
If you will. Like, not an intrinsic, I fill up my own cup.
100%.
It's like, you fucking get that external. 100%. 250,000 people are
but for me to go from The Voice stage and then going to play, like, a small little venue or even a coffee shop, I don't look at it like, oh, this sucks that I'm playing a coffee shop. I'm like,
cool,
I'm still getting my
shop.
I'm still singing. I'm making a connection. The goal for me is to make a connection with people through my music.
Yeah. Can we all just be honest? The goal is to make money.
Doing what you like to do.
Doing
what
you like to do.
And that's no different than.
A dick. Yeah.
But it's
really
true. It's true. And I hate when artists or anybody say I'm in it for the music or whatever. But there's some truth to that, I'm sure. But for me, yeah, I want to do music, but that's because it's the only thing I'm really good at. You know, I didn't finish college. I couldn't.
Right.
It I'm like screwed. You, like, yeah. This is it. This is all I have to do.
I didn't finish college.
And you have an IQ of 160.
Nine.
Did you know most of the wealthiest people in this world never finish school? It's not a precursor for
Bill
success.
Gates.
Is that the statistics?
Which Steve Jobs.
There's a ton of statistics, yeah. College is a scam. It's a money-making machine.
Which I do believe, especially now, because now they're looking at people that graduate on a higher percentage. So it's like you go and get your degree, which back in the day you just have a bachelor's, but now it's like they're not even looking. You have a bachelor's? Masters.
Well, it's like that you and matter. I, even if we went to college, we're not working on Wall Street. Sorry. I'm not. Maybe you are, but I don't think I am.
You were,
I don't know.
You were near Wall Street.
Listen, I'm the second famous person to graduate from my high school. The first, I'll give it to her. She was my first girl-on-girl experience. Sorry, Dana. Perino. Dana Perino.
She even gave the last name. Her phone number is 303-6-7.
No, it was, you know, anyway, Dana Perino was the Speaker of the House for George Bush when Tony Snow got cancer and stepped down, so Dana was the Speaker of the House. So I always think that I'm more famous than Dana, clearly, but Dana has more followers on Facebook.
How many does she have?
Gotta fix that. I don't know. She has a like page, and she puts up pictures of her dog Jasper. I want to kill. I've never wanted.
So you're stalking her.
I don't ever. No. Somebody. She's on the feed. She's on the feed. On the feed all the time with Jasper the dog. Jasper's America's dog. You can watch her on. I think it's the Five on Fox.
Like an
I can't stand Jasper.
We're not
I want.
At all.
She dresses him up in the most ridiculous clothes, and it's a dog that it weighs the size of you.
Whoa! Is that a fat joke?
Swear to God, no, it's not. But I'm going to show you a picture of Jasper right now.
I'm trying to think. I don't think anybody famous has come out of my high school.
No, except for you.
Well.
Let's thank you, first of all.
Right.
let me see the Jasper pick of the day. Hold on.
I'm trying to think if there's anybody that.
Oh, yeah, here.
There's Jasper today. Hi, Jasper. So every day she posts a picture.
Yeah, he's America's dog. Yep. This was last night. That's a comfy towel.
Chris,
does anyone.
Anybody famous out of
That's
your high
Jasper.
School?
Yeah, several.
Who?
Baseball players, Matt Williams, played for the Giants for a long time. Dale Rasner, who played baseball. Me.
Where did you go to high school?
There's a couple actors who came out of my high school.
Where'd you go to high school?
Carson Heights in Nevada, Reno, Tahoe area.
Mm-hmm.
We had a big high school. It was like 3,500 students.
Yeah.
And people could mail to LA from there.
Yeah, it's not far.
Yeah.
San Francisco.
I'm trying to think. I don't think there's one famous person out of Ivor C. Ranum in the hood.
Oh my gosh, my friend Angie went to Ranum. How old are you?
Yep.
And so you know Angie.
Yes, I am.
We graduated around the same time, Trace.
Yeah, thank you.
Should we
and
talk
Angie
about that?
Might know each other. Yes, you should.
Where did you go to high school?
Clemens High School in Sugarland, Texas.
Down in Sugarland.
Down south, baby. I had one guy in my graduating class that who is now on the television show The Strain. It's weird, dude, because he went by Michael Gomez, and then he got signed by Jay-Z and went by Aztec, and then got kicked off of his label because he lied about his upbringing. He was pretending he was...
He wasn't street, and he said
he wasn't street, and he said that he was.
Vanilla Ice.
I swear. And then
I just had a Robert Van Winkle moment.
He goes by Miguel Gomez.
He was sitting in a meeting, creative meeting. Like, I would have loved to have been there.
I know.
Okay, we're down to Aztec and fucking
and Pyro. Where are we going?
I would have been like,
what would
Aztec?
What would your rap name be?
Name?
Hold on, wait. What would your rap name be if
Sea Murder, for sure.
Sea Murder.
See how quick that was?
Wow. I'm not saying there's not a Sea Murder video out.
Wow.
Do you have a rap name, Chris?
I don't know. High C. I can hit a high C.
Okay. That wasn't the question, you asshole.
Well, hey, fine, mine's Gatorade.
So you're saying my rap name can't be High C?
No, it's High C. I love
it. It can be, but not for those reasons.
Mine's Gatorade, then.
Gatorade?
It's wow. High C on Gatorade.
He's like, I can hit a High C.
I don't have a rap name. I need a gangster name. When I was
T-Rev.
No, when I was in high school.
That's actually not.
they call me Trey Cray, but that's more of gangster slash.
That's more like inner city girl.
My high school.
Ask that bitch. You hold my earrings. You hold my hair.
You better back the fuck up, girl.
My high school
was
hood.
I know how to get in a fight, and you are going to want to hear this.
Yeah. My high school was hood as hell, like North Denver. Like
I can fight hood.
It's North shitty. Daniels, like, eh? Off Federal in North Denver is where I went to high school, and there was tons of gangs. And so the
like, Eliches.
No, we're way poorer than the Eliches neighborhood then. me and like the five guys I hung out with created our own gang because we couldn't be in any of the other gangs because we were white. And we were called the Wrecking Crew, TWC. Yeah, we totally had like a logo and everything.
Fuck yeah.
Oh my god. Did you have like a flash? Like I keep West Coast.
I think we did. I think we had West a gang Coast. Sign, but I can't remember it yet.
I'm sorry, I'm really
bad at that. But I was called Takedown.
Once again, because super I wrestled.
Is that not the worst thing in the entire world?
It's pretty bad.
No, the seriously. Worst thing is
it's better than ISIS.
Yeah.
Right? Fucking nerds.
The worst thing is getting into a fight with a girl that is of a different race in a bar that you're the whitest one in.
I'm going to go ahead and say Tracy does not reflect the views of Unfiltered and Unaffected.
I don't. But I was at this place called Purple Martini, and it was really packed. Yeah, my husband worked
there. That place is full of cougars.
Cougars for everybody.
That's what they were in the DTC.
Cougar?
I was combing it, all right? I was a cougar in there. What the fuck do you think I was in there for? I was cougaring in the whole place. Anyway, so I'm coming out of the bathroom and I bump into this girl.
What were you doing in the bathroom?
Well, I wish that they have attendants in there. No, I think we just had to go to the bathroom. And my husband works in the VIP section.
Number one or number two?
Stop!
Would you have sex with Burt Reynolds today or 1970s Burt Reynolds?
70s all day, every day. Who doesn't want a mustache?
Let's talk about something important.
Back it up. I'm going to tell you how to fight a black girl right now. Do you not want to know? Whoa. Do you not want to be known?
You just got
to
touch her hair. Like,
girl, no, this is what you do. A girl was ready to kick my ass. I bumped into her and I'm like, I'm sorry. She's like, you want to go? She's ready to rip the earrings off and whatever.
You looked around like, where? Yeah.
No, I learned from one of my friends, Nikki. Nikki Sworn. I'm not sure if you know Nikki.
Her phone number is 303.
She's amazing. she says, well, you know, if you ever get in a fight in a bar, this is what you do. You back yourself up to the bar and you reach behind. And you know the little soda thing that you and I figured out?
That bitch has watched way too many films.
you just pick up your soda gun from behind the bar because you can reach it. It's right there within reach. You saw me reach it. You can reach the soda gun and you say, bitch, you like your hair when you came in? You like want different hair when you leave. Because I'm going to fuck that weave up right now.
No, wait. Time out. Right. Did you actually do that? Because in your mind, sometimes I'm like, I'm a badass in my head.
I had to say it.
I owned it.
I said this.
I would have missed it. I'm like flicking other.
No, I had it. I grabbed it. I knew the bartender and he was like, what are you doing? And I just said, nothing. And I said, do you want to walk in here with the same hair you walked out? Do you want to walk out with the same hair you walked in? And she goes, what? And I go, I like your hair. How long did that take to get done? And I'm like ready to push the squirter on her. She's like, I'm sorry. Never mind. Gone like freight train.
Oh, that doesn't work on
just guys. Do that. Just go over their head.
Over their head.
No, Ron.
That would scare me because my hair is pretty sweet.
You've got some good
actually,
gel.
You do have good hair.
Chris Miller has different hair often, and I've been friends with him long enough to see about five different styles. Chris Miller hair.
What's
he
the
went
best?
From like, he had like, long everywhere with like the kind of greasy look, like but then he would wear like
that's very chocolate.
But then he would wear like my daughter's headbands in it. Those little the thin string.
Yeah, the cute
so
one.
So it's just like up to here.
Yeah,
he would have just the bangs, and it would just be like a poof sticking out.
That's awesome.
Do you remember that look, Chris?
It's like soccer. It was like Euro trash.
No, yeah. I was just gonna say I totally soccer like players. That's fiber. Hot.
Very thick.
It's like there's something about Mary in their hair.
Do you have curly hair?
Super curly.
Wow.
Yeah.
So when it was long, was it just like this wild?
Fro.
It was like
it's like long, it's like long blonde locks.
It's like tighter curls.
You're gorgeous. Wow. We're both gonna do. You know what? I'm we're handsome. Just yeah. I think we're
gonna film that after.
I was
the other.
We're gonna fight over you with a stick. Soda bottle thing.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna mess up her weave.
Stick around for the porn after shoot.
The after show.
That would be weird.
We're talking about world viral.
Stand in line for that.
Or ISIS. My name will be ISIS during the porn.
Yes. Oh, God. That's awesome.
You guys want to see something cool?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Y'all want to see a dead body?
You're a fucking asshole, Chris. You're a fucking asshole.
Oh!
Look at your face, dude.
Oh!
There you go. That's
that awesome. Was awesomely cool, and I'm glad we don't have my videos popped up. Thank you.
We'll find some.
Yeah, we'll get you.
Oh,
don't worry.
No, we won't.
Those be X-rayed.
Hidden behind that calculator.
Chris.
Yeah.
Not cool, bro.
Well, it'll probably happen again.
Not,
you can wear it.
Not cool.
How do you use these?
It's like a scrunchie for your...
Like a knot?
You know, if this was elementary school, you guys would be in a relationship right
now.
You
think so?
You totally just let
him... Do you like me?
Yes or no?
Do you want to use my hair
clip? No, maybe allowed.
Do you want to use my hair clip?
Do you want to... Here you go.
He totally wore my hair clip.
No, if he liked her, he would have pulled her hair. That's how you know when
that's going to happen later.
I know.
That's not right now, right now, but later, later.
When you're 6 years old, how you know when boys like you is when they pull your hair.
And also when you're 35.
Well, that's when you know they really like you. Well, I mean, it could rock a tranny room.
That's not good.
Tranny.
Okay, speaking of tranny rooms, this is going to move us on to the next
one. Hey, hi, C. If you thought you were hooking up with a chick once, sorry, Trevor, this is about trannies. If you met a girl in a bar and she started making out with her, and then you got to the bathroom and she started giving you head, right? And you're about to finish, so you're like, I want to return the favor, and you reach down and she had a dick. Would you let her finish?
Probably not. No.
Chris would.
Would you?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Would you?
If you're right at the end.
All right. Well, if you're at the end, yeah.
But then what happens after?
You just leave, right? You don't give.
Do you have a... What's up, bro? Good job, bro.
Bro.
Do you owe... Do you owe him?
Because I went to school to be a sex therapist, and I don't think they
I don't know how I would react. I'd probably be a little upset.
You would be.
Yeah.
But you would come.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. I'm like 30 now, so it's coming is like... You got to take those wins when you get them.
So,
wait, 30? You're 30?
Yeah.
And that's the peak?
I'm not saying it's the peak.
Okay. Oh, okay.
I had a bunch of chicken wings last night and got chicken wing wasted, and my whole morning's been shit. So, like, the point is like, when you get to this age, there's just less, less activity.
I've been food wasted, too. I get it.
But let me ask you this, Chris. We go into the green room and turn off the light, which that room is pitch black. All of us go in there. Mm-hmm. Your pants get unzipped, and you start getting a handy, mm-hmm. and you're... 5 seconds away from finishing, and the lights go on, and it's Chris.
Yeah?
He'd be happy.
You finish?
He'd be happy.
Yeah.
You finish?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, look at me, dude.
I'm not going to pull away and not finish. Am I looking one of them in the eyes?
You look down, and that's it.
No, I know, but are these two in the room?
Yeah. They're
all fully dressed.
And they're looking me in the eye?
No. They're looking at you with shame.
Yeah. I'm laughing. I'm pointing and laughing.
Well, either way, she's still looking at me, so I'm like, there's some eroticism.
You know, I'm looking and I'm waiting to join. So
here's the thing: I have a good enough imagination that I can.
You could block Chris out completely. Yeah. Even staring at his face,
I'm
you could
super,
block him
I'm
out.
I'm super creative.
Yeah. I got a lot of facial hair, though. You know.
This is so.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah,
can
I mean,
we go to Craigslist to get a trainee?
If I'm almost there, I'm going to let him finish. And I'll probably just stare you in the eye so I don't have to look at him.
Okay.
That makes sense.
He's speaking, just a tool
that makes sense.
Speaking of trannies, I
and I worked with cross-dressers and transsexuals. They're very informative.
I love CrossFit, too.
I have, right? I was reading through the trending things on Facebook last night. Mm-hmm. Facebook is now coming down on... on drag queens, making them change their profiles to their legitimate names and blocking their profile until they do, because they cannot use their drag name.
Why?
Because in the terms and conditions that you agree to when you join Facebook, you agree to be only you, representing you, that you can't be someone else.
Whatever, catfish. Give me a break on that. That's bullshit.
So
I'm a drag queen. My name is Sassy Sue, but really my name is Stu.
Right.
I'm gonna have my Facebook page with my fan likeage and all that shit all up there with my feather boa.
Now what they're saying is they can only create a fan page for the character that they play. What's up, Tim?
What's up?
They can only create
a Facebook is a business. It's so if you don't like it, go fuck yourself.
Right.
I don't agree with like this isn't like a public company.
Yeah, right.
It's not like the city of Denver's
rules.
And they're saying this is a private company, so
whatever
you may not agree with it, but
it's their rules.
Well, I own a company, and if there's certain things that don't happen, I'm just to fuck off.
So like, you think that the drag queens should have to use this real name?
No, you're getting into it. There's two lines here. There's one of like ethics, or not ethics, but saying, hey, I have the freedom to do. Yeah, you do.
Mm-hmm.
You absolutely do.
Mm-hmm.
But this is my business. And so
this is how I want it represented, and that's the way.
Yeah, if you come into my restaurant and you take your pants off, I like it.
I'm into it. I might even let you give me a hand job.
But I like money.
Yeah.
But so you have to leave.
But
so
the wait staff, I don't agree with that. I think that you should be able to be whoever you want to be.
Now,
but you can, though.
But here's the deal.
But if they're going to crack down on them, how is that being who you want to be?
Well, but I've
Facebook
heard
is saying.
Oh, go ahead. Sorry.
What Facebook is saying they can do is create a fan page for their character that they play.
Sure. Well, but I mean, musicians have that too. I have, you know, different names or whatever.
Right, I've got
it,
my homepage, and then if I had a big enough ego, would do a fan page. Catch that next time.
I have a fan page.
You do?
I'm a narcissist. Are
oh
you fucking kidding
God.
Me?
Oh, my God. Yeah, my thing hit 5,000, and I said, thank fucking God, 2 years ago.
No, it's just a show page.
Yeah, oh, I don't. Yeah.
I have a bulldog named Winston.
But I heard, though, that Facebook was going to let you, where it said like male or female, that they were going to have a transgender option. So why would you add a transgender option but not let them have pages with that
right
sassy stew name?
I don't know that I agree with it 100% because as a public figure, there are a lot of public figures that don't go by their given name, A, to protect their children, B, to, I've never had the opportunity of a stalker.
Seriously?
Yeah, no stalkers ever in my life.
Jesus, take the wheel.
Tim's going to stalk me.
Wait, you've never had someone stalk you?
No, I've never had a stalker, like a Facebook stalk, you know, like... Like the obsessed fan thing, I've never had it.
I've had a few, and I'm into it.
Yeah.
So if you,
if anyone wants to,
I'll hit you later. Don't worry. I got you.
It seems as I mean, if there's a lot of actors that have Facebook pages, and we know most of their names are not the given name that we know them by.
Amanda Bynes.
Right.
I'm hitting like three times on that one.
I'm trying to remember the chick from Can't Buy Me Love. Do you remember that movie?
I do, and Patrick Dempsey was in it on a lawnmower.
Yeah, we went to...
Don't care who the girl is, but
we both went to college at UNC.
Yeah.
And that's not...
That's not her name.
No.
Wait, so what's your... So you're saying that they're discriminating and that they shouldn't be able to do that?
Well, Zuckerberg can do whatever the fuck he wants. Because he's...
Zuckerberg?
Yeah.
I tuned out for a second.
Because he's the... I mean...
I have really bad ADD.
He writes.
So
the
more
he writes the terms and conditions.
Right.
So it's his company. We don't pay for it. I would be, maybe if I had to pay for Facebook and then they started doing things like that, I would have some argument. But they give it to us for free, so we kind of have to.
Okay,
pay
so let me
rules.
Ask you a question. You guys own a restaurant, right? It's a nice family place.
Yeah.
And a group of skinheads walks in, and they're kind of obnoxious, and they're making other people uncomfortable. And do you ask them to leave?
No.
Come on.
Nope.
Bullshit. You're going to let...
Are they being obnoxious? Are they really doing...
I mean, it's like, if it's cop-worthy calling, absolutely.
Are they like...
But that's not discrimination. That's,
are they
I would
like,
have done that to anybody.
F those N-words this. And
well, there's always the signs
everywhere
you go.
Where I'm going with this is that Facebook polices certain things also to protect, I'm guessing, the community. Where, like, you can't throw racial shit around and you can't put up naked pictures, right? They police some of that.
Yeah, Facebook, I got killed by Maris the Great a year and a half ago, and he put up the photo shoot, and it was awesome. Brains hanging out, everything.
They probably took it down.
And then he posted the pictures as an album, and Facebook themselves pulled them down and said, we can't have it. It's too
graphic.
And I was like, no, I'm not dead. It's really me. Look.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Dude, to preface it, too, I'm open. I'm the least.
Oh, we know.
Yeah, dude, I'm the least judgmental guy.
You're wearing a beret right now. We know you're on.
No, I'm just saying, like if a tranny, I'd be into, hey, cool, look at the outfit you put together. Like, that's just, you're
right,
cool.
Head
like,
to toe.
Fine. If you,
on point.
You know what? You're madder than me. If you can take a dick in the ass, that sounds terrible. You're way tougher than I am, because that obviously takes some grit, right?
So we heard.
Grit. Good for you. But I'm guessing part of it is maybe, like, that idea of what I'm saying, if a group of neo-Nazis came into your place, and it's so disruptive that it's affecting other people.
A neo-Nazi could be whatever is offensive to you.
Oh, I just picked drag
queens.
Right, but I'm
because
saying
drag queens offend the Christians.
Everything.
I'm not, because I don't agree with it either. They shouldn't necessarily censorship is wrong, right? Like, you should just be
able to be.
But this, I bet where Facebook is coming from is that it's a community, and that there's certain things.
If
that
they're pulling down the anal rape video, they have to pull down the drag queen.
Right.
Is that what you're saying?
Okay. So I'm guessing when they had the meeting, there was a conversation that was like, look, there's there's enough, because I know some gay dudes who like if there's anyone gay listening to this, like
call Chris.
You win. Like it's
equal.
It's game over. Like you don't see heterosexuals running around like, I'm fucking hetero and I'm fucking proud, bitch. Like I can't.
You do.
I just exudes. He's wearing a beret. It exudes from my pores. Yeah, I'm very alpha. You guys win. So like I know gay guys who take it to this like super gay level of just like in your gay. Face, like fucking calm down.
Well, dude. It'd be like, the same thing. But if I don't like that, then I'm just gonna block you or unfriend you or not be part of your Facebook. Is basically yeah.
No, I'm just playing devil's advocate.
Yeah. Oh, and absolutely, right. I think that's totally Facebook's stance on it. If it's like some, they've got enough complaints, you know.
They
got
to play the middle.
They're gonna have to play the middle ground to keep everybody happy, and yeah. I'm not gonna fucking pay for Facebook. So
right.
End the story there.
I just continue.
I ain't paying for this shit.
I continue to believe that Facebook needs me more than I need them.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Okay. That's how I believe.
This check that ego.
Hey, we have about 15 minutes left. We want to get Monica in Studio B with her guitar. Chris and I, real quick, Chris and I went to Sam's Number 3 last Friday. We try to do dinner and a movie every week where one of us goes and reviews a local restaurant of some kind, and then usually I see a movie. But because I've been in Fight Camp, I haven't been to the movies recently, and the media company's pissed at me, so you might need to go to some movies.
I can take in a flick.
Anyway, we went to Sam's Number 3. Do we have any?
If it works on this computer.
We can check it out. If you've not been there, it's on 15th and Curtis, one
it's
below Champion.
It's called Behind My Husband's Bar.
Right. Sam's Number 3.
Sam's Number 3, behind Labo. And it's really good for hangover food.
The breakfast burrito is as big as the plate.
And if you want some grilled cheese, Sam's Number 3 is a spot.
So we went to Sam's Number 3. 15th
they didn't invite
and Curtis.
Me, but whatever.
No, you ran out of here.
You didn't even invite me. It's an invitation.
The wait, we went at lunchtime. The wait was like 15 minutes, but they were popping through people. I mean, they were working hard and get it. The service was great. The food, I love the burritos there. I need to order things other than the burrito, but the burrito was awesome.
Rock a grilled cheese, why don't you?
What'd you think, Chris?
I thought it was pretty good, man. The breakfast burritos were slamming. We went in there. We had to wait for a little while, so that was it wasn't too bad actually for lunch, but the food was really good. Here's Trevor and I hanging out.
There's some video of us
branding the.
That's also
the
where I took a picture of the douchiest thing on earth.
Oh yeah.
There's a guy paying. We're standing right where they pay on the way out, and there's a guy, and he had sweatpants with like turquoise socks pulled up over the sweatpants and nice. Penny loafers.
Let me see if I can find that real quick.
Did you have it on video?
Was he paying in $2
bills? No, I don't have that on video, but you shared it on
Facebook. Yeah, I Instagrammed it the other day.
Oh.
Yes, I was on my phone the whole time. Anyway, Sam's Number 3, 15th and Curtis. I give it 2 thumbs up. I love that place. Dan Maurer is the manager there. He's a great guy. His little brother's Mike Maurer from the music scene in Denver, if any of you guys are looking around. But it's dope, and it's kind of that downtown, cool, edgy vibe. The hipsters took it over for a while, but we're getting it back.
Yeah.
There's the dude's feet.
Yeah, look.
What is this?
That's pretty dope, dude.
Yeah, that's cool, right?
You could actually rock that.
Yeah, that's pretty sick.
I actually kind of see you with Prada maybe on, but yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, no.
So you want to go to a tune and then come back?
Yeah, can we go to cut to a commercial? Do you have the Coils commercial?
I do.
We can play that.
Do it.
Let me see here.
Oh, my God. We didn't break it all, and I'm fucking tired now.
Oh my
God, that was a fun show.
This is Jasper, Dana's dog that she dresses up every day.
It's true, I crave you.
Herman's Hideaway, on the corner of Iowa and Broadway, your favorite independent anti-corporate venue, featuring Westward's best patio. Now serving award-winning food. From metal to jazz to hip-hop, Herman's Hideaway has something for everyone. And if you want to book your act at Herman's Hideaway, email booking@hermanshideaway.com or call 303-777-2535. There's only one venue, family owned and operated for over 50 years. Holding it down in Denver. Go to hermanshideaway.com for more information and show listings.
Anxious, baby. Yeah. List of 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. It says thou shalt fear no man but God, but damn it's hard when the devil playing his card. You either claim you insane or they slam the bars. Last stand on the cross in the land of the lost. I'm a man, I'm a boss, I'ma battle the depths. I'ma walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I'ma blast till there ain't no other ammo is left. I'ma handle scandals and threats, then abandon my flesh. I'm just expanding my set. My spirit's calmer than it's ever been. People been telling me my whole life that I'll never win. Others say I better win. Tip top, heaven sent. Touchdown, underground, hip hop veteran. Buying what I'm selling's not a typical sale. I got centrifugal forces forcing open indivisible jails. Spiritual takes over when physical fails. I met God from putting Yale on a digital scale. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. Already know my steelo, I'm flyer than the ego. Looking down into the eyes of the devil and see the evil. I go my own way like Carlito. Plus half these rappers is actors like Johnny Depp and Al Pacino. What you think I sing for? I'm trying to get my story told. This could be my theme song, I could call it Glory Road. They look hard on the outside, but they soft on the inside like an Oreo. I'm taking over for a decade like the Aikman 80s and plaguing through the villages until there's anxious babies. I see my homeboys in the cut blazing buds and all my junkie homies on the corner craving drugs. I got respect for every person, every people. I ain't better than no one and I ain't worse than them either. This verse about to be done, keep it on the down low. This is how you count dough. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 3.5, 14, 28, 112, 448,000 on the scale. That's the 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo. 8.5 ounce, quarter pound and a kilo.
Oh, let's say go. Hey, Chris, you're standing.
Yeah,
got your head.
Ready? Yeah, you're on.
I'm on. Wait, no 3, 2, 1 again. You fuck up the intro.
3, 2, 1.
Hey.
Hey.
We're back.
It's your boy.
Monika Leigh from The Voice in studio. She's going to play a tune that we have not heard ever before, mostly because I don't know.
Mostly because it's my song.
That's
so that would make sense.
That's what I meant. Enjoy, guys.
So this song I'm going to be playing at Herman's Hideaway here September 27th, next Saturday. So make sure that you guys are here. We're headlining. The band is called Monika Leigh and the Swamp Rebels. So please come out.
Thank you.
to disguise. Oh, no. Hold my breath and count to three. Don't forget to breathe. Close my eyes and count to ten. Oh, my breath, we're going again. You guys all right? This dirty water feels the same. And so I've showered myself in shame. Hold my breath and count to three. Don't forget to breathe. Close my eyes and count to ten. Oh my God. To be.
Holy. Hey, Chris, move your ass. Move your ass, Chris.
That's Monika Leigh.
Monika Leigh. And the. What's the name of the band? The full name?
Rebels.
Monika Leigh and the Rebels. Swamp Rebels.
That sounds like a bunch of rough New Orleans guys, huh? like Duck Dynasties.
Do they have beards? Does the band have beards?
I wish, but no.
Make them grow beards.
One guy's kind of hairy. Does that count?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then yeah.
Okay.
He's got a body beard.
Oh. Ooh. I just found a picture on Facebook of body hair leggings. So guys, I'll stop looking at you. Oh. And it's a full legging of like man hair. Like,
oh god.
And so it's like dudes will not look at you like that anymore. I just say, why don't you just wear pants?
Yeah,
if you don't want your legs checked out.
We're just about
what
done.
Are you doing?
We're just wrapping it up, Chris.
We're just gonna finish usually your flirt fest and you guys can go fuck later.
Usually we just wrap it up at this point pretty much. Monika will be playing Herman's Hideaway on the 27th,
next Saturday.
Tickets, online tickets?
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, there'll be some availability at the door, but probably very little. So
just our
tickets.
Comps, I'm guessing, are going to be available at the door. Right. So. Well, we don't wait in line, remember?
Line.
Okay, good.
But you have to come in through the back.
Oh, by the hotel. I can't come in through
You
the
can't
back.
Come to the show.
I won't do it. I won't go in through the back.
Tracy's scared of the alley. It's so awesome.
I park on Broadway every time I go.
We're talking about Monika. You actually coming in the alley, right?
Yeah.
This is why she needs the hairy leggings.
This weekend, what's everybody have going on? What do you have going on at Herman's?
This weekend, tonight, we have a band called Color and Tomahawk Fox. Tomorrow, we have...
And the Hits.
And the Hits.
Yeah, my wife's band.
Yeah, your wife's band will be here. So why are you asking me if you already know?
You have a wife?
Why are you asking me if you already know? Yeah, Trevor's wife, Kristen's band, will be playing tonight with a couple other bands, so that should be a party. My charity, Mile High Scenesters, is doing a kids show tomorrow, so I'll be here all day doing that. And then we have Mr. Steak.
I'll be here all day.
No, literally.
Doing charity for children.
It's going to be awesome. No, I'll be here from 11 a.m. till about 4 a.m.
Cool.
But you can take some of those weirdo pills that he has, and then you're going to be focused.
Dude, I'm stoked,
and fun.
Dude. Those pills are great, man.
Oh yeah, he takes them every day. But
I think he like eats. Some
he's
like
super
high
strung. Yeah, no, this is focused, Chris.
Oh yeah,
yeah, that's awesome.
He gets up and like walks around. And, let's see. This weekend tonight, I will be here at Herman's with my wife's band, The Hits, for their show. Looking forward to this one. They've been working on some new material. That'll be cool. Tomorrow, I will be at the Cyborg Seminar. One of the world champion Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champions is coming to do a seminar. I got invited to go and do it and film an interview with him, which will then be on Shameless MMA right here on worldviral.tv Sunday.
Nice.
Sunday. Tune in if you're an MMA fan. Myself, Matt Sierra, Connor Cordova, talking about everything MMA for 2 hours on Sunday. We'll be here.
Sounds great.
Pretty cool stuff.
Anybody else? Chris, you got anything going on?
Her, Monica. Yeah. Fine, get him off Monica's leg. He might have plans.
No, last weekend I went hard, and so this weekend, I'm a huge, huge college football fan. I played college football. I'm just into it. Like, I love everything about it. So we have in my house, we have a 68-inch TV and then three TVs above it.
Oh, my God.
So you can watch all the games.
The NFL Network with all 12.
Yeah, Jesus. I'm such a dude. I'm going to, like, work out in the morning and then just watch college football.
I'm getting so much testosterone right now as I go over.
You and I
did something.
I'm going to beat the shit out of someone.
You and I are, like, the polar opposites.
Why?
Because he's watching Real Housewives of Melbourne. That's why.
I have not watched a football game in probably 2 years.
It's not, any type. It's not like
any type of football. I just haven't.
Why?
Because I've been training like crazy and like my focus is somewhere else.
Okay.
It's just not.
Yeah, no,
Real Housewives are on.
This is the first Saturday
conflicting.
That I've had that like.
It's kind of like football.
It makes me feel like it, everything's okay. Like it brings me back to a time when like my mom was making like potato soup and there's like.
Aww.
I have a sweater on and it's like there's
leaves. Oh, you're
falling.
So.
It's so sensitive and nice.
He just made my nipples hurt again. Oh, Charles.
You
sweet.
Know what I am? I'm like a Sour Patch Kid. At one moment, you're like, this guy's a fucking prick. And then the next minute, I kind of like him.
I'm like, I want to take you home.
I kind of like
leash.
Him moments.
I want to take you home on a leash. With
the kind of like him's come way less often than I fucking hate him's. But that kind of like him moments are good, I guess.
I think, I don't know. I like
anyway, this is this has been Unfiltered and Unaffected right here on worldviral.tv. Our Friday edition is over. We've got to go be real people.
Good job, team. Really good stuff.
Thanks. Nice work, team. Nice
good
work.
Job. Good work, everybody. Good work. Good work.
Good
work.
Stuff.
Nice. Good work.
Like
Chris,
engineer,
next
Chris.
Week we get the intro. Next week. We got it.
We'll see what happens. See you next Friday.
Yet musical, known to make a crowd move so beautiful. With the crucial flow, never the usual. But sometimes it ain't the what but the who, you know. So allow me to reintroduce my flow. The Don Dilly say hello, a moose, your goose. The two, the crew, you know. What's the fools you don't? Stay focused through the booze and blow. Disillusion, no, we on cruise control. Forget the do's and don'ts. Tryna make it to the tit off like a guru flow. With buku dough, breaking bread like clay pots. I take shots, everything I say's high. Stay cocked like Doc screaming gray sky. With Marty McFly, we get retardedly high. Try to topple the skies until a part of you dies. And yo, you finally realize, maybe you find you surprised. Yo, that the harder you try, that's the farther you rise. So take your father's advice, cause yo, it starts from his eye. So keep your mind sharp as a knife, cause at the start of your life, that's when you're starting to die. Why I try to keep it level with some positive vibes. Try to conquer the skies.